I wish I would have got that,
yeah.
But I didn't. I was about to, and then I was like, oh, let me check the video stuff, and then you said it.
I said it. So, it's been a long night. Been a long day.
Been a long few weeks.
Yeah, but we're finally getting into it.
Yeah. Hey, folks, welcome back to another episode of You, Me, and Dice. I'm Eddie.
And I'm Tommy.
And it's been, we're listening to this, it's been a few weeks, I think.
I think maybe two, yeah.
Some changes in work schedules, new positions stepping into, so there's some changes on the outside world, outside of the podcast, and yeah, we can't record as consistently as we used to,
yeah.
So the plan is to, instead of doing an episode every week, it's an episode every 2 weeks, and it's just longer.
Longer episodes.
Yeah, longer episodes.
More of us talking.
More of us talking. And I think I don't really have a recording schedule in like when we'll record. I mean, it's just between the release of this podcast and the next one, we'll record in sometime between those weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Ideally with enough time for me to edit the longer episode. But yeah, that's the thing. So this episode should be going out. I'm trying to pull up my calendar here.
In about 2 hours. Just...
It should go out next Friday, basically, February the 24th.
Oh, okay.
And then 2 weeks after that, March 10th, so on and so forth.
Look at that. Time's already flying by. Like,
yeah, dude.
2023. It's already, like, when you think about it like that, right? February 24th, that's the end of February. Yeah. That's 2 months down. And, wow, fuck, right?
You know, when I was in my old job,
mm-hmm.
I didn't like working there. And I would, like, look forward to the weekend, you know. And it made the week go by a lot slower.
Yeah, yeah.
It was just like, oh, yo, Friday. But then
even the weekend feels fast, right?
Even the weekend felt fast.
It's already Saturday night.
Right, yeah. Now. But
that means I got to go back in, like, 30 hours, right?
Yeah.
To work. Fuck. No?
Well, see, the thing is, like, at that job, it felt fast, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this one, the week feels like it goes by really fast at my job. I'm always busy. I'm always doing something. I enjoy it more, and the weekend still goes by fast. It feels, but it's more enjoyable actually.
Mm.
Like it's more enjoyable because I'm not stressing to get back to work.
Yeah.
Like, I gotta go back to work. Monday, it's not like that at all. It's like, all right, time to get back to it. So, it makes the weekends more enjoyable.
No, I get you. I get you.
Because before it was like, kind of like, like, oh no, the weekend needs to last. And, you know.
Or like, you want to fill your weekend with something like, hey, I gotta do something. I can't.
Yeah, I gotta do something. And like, before I return to this shithole job.
Yeah, I always feel like, man, I need that one first day to decompress. And then you only have one day to do anything.
Pretty much.
It fucking sucks, right? And I don't know if you heard about some of the schools in HISD. HISD, I think, is the one. They're implementing a...
Houston Independent School District.
Yeah, Houston. Yeah, exactly. They're implementing a 4-day weekend pretty soon.
4-day?
Four-day workday.
Yeah.
Because
so 4 days for school.
Yeah. Because of the shortage of teachers. That's what I heard.
I mean, this could
at least that's what I saw in the Houston, you know, the Chronicle.
Right. This could be sort of a stepping stone towards a 4-day work week.
We can help. Because even one of my friends that's a teacher, he was like, he showed us some of the scheduling that they've implemented. And like, he has a pretty good amount of days off now. Because of they're trying to figure ways out to, you know,
get teachers
and not necessarily do the 5-day, you know, 5-day or do the 4-day work day. they still want to keep the 5-day, but they don't have enough people to cycle through. Yeah.
Well, so, I mean, nobody wants to be a fucking teacher because
the pay is garbage.
They pay shit. They get treated like shit. They get paid like shit. I mean, and I know a lot of the people who do teaching is for two reasons. One, they're stuck there. They got nowhere else to go. Mm-hmm. Another one is people, they love it.
Yeah.
They love the teaching and they deal with the shit pay and everything because they enjoy that. They actually enjoy that career.
Mm-hmm. So one of the things I wanted to get into today, what did we just fucking eat, devour today? We went to lunch together, or
we went, yeah.
We went to a feast, a massacre. I don't know what would you call it.
I would call it a light meal.
Oh, Jesus Christ. It was not. But so we went to go get crawfish. You know, crawfish seasons, it should be upon us already. I think it's already happening. It should be. So we went to go get crawfish, and we went to go get Vietnamese crawfish. I think it's called Viet Cajun, which is, I didn't know this, right? They wrote an article in, I think in the Chronicle, where it's like, Houston is where it originated, like, Viet Cajun. Like, the mixture.
I think there's a big population of Vietnamese in Houston.
Yeah, there is. And they've sort of fused the spices of, you know, their culture and the Cajun culture, you know, the bayou and all that. And people love it, man, right? It's
good. It's been our go-to spot for years now.
Yeah, for years.
Yeah,
for
years, man, like, years.
Like, more than six, I think.
Yeah, because...
This was even before you went to Japan.
Yeah, no, I remember going there when I was at my first apartment. Like, my first apartment where I was there alone.
Guys, I remember when it was $4.99 a pound.
Yeah, it was $4.99 a pound. But, it ain't that no more.
Yeah, no.
I think that was $7.99, right?
Yeah, $7.99, which isn't that bad compared to other places.
Yeah.
I
mean, the service is good.
Yeah, yeah. And
they're really nice.
Yeah, they're nice and they do a good job. And, you know, one of my things that I didn't speak up about it, but they didn't have any ice. So I'm like, just go to the gas station. Look at some ice. You know? But
I'm actually glad that they didn't have ice. Yeah. I feel like it waters down my iced tea.
Really?
I get that it's iced tea, but they call it sweet tea.
Mm.
But I'm not a big fan of ice. If I can make the drink cold without ice, I'm all for it. Mm. I like crushed ice.
Crushed ice.
I guess it just depends on... I gotta feel it, you know?
Yeah.
And the place, sometimes, you know, you get a fucking drink and they fill, like, the entire cup with ice. And then they fill, like,
well,
the
rest with water. Yeah, exactly. That's, they know that to do... They do that to do refills, right? Like, just, you know, they fill it up with ice and then they don't ever have to give you ice again.
Yeah, but...
But again, it does water down.
I mean, if I go through a fucking drive-thru, you give me an entire fucking cup of ice.
Oh, I hate that.
I fucking hate that.
You know who does that? Sonic.
Sonic
does that. I have to tell them, you know, oh, give me a cherry lime.
Yeah.
Light ice. I have to.
You know who else does that? Chick-fil-A.
Fucking
those cheese-loving motherfuckers.
Who else? Raising Cane's does that.
Raising Cane's does that, yeah.
Son of a bitch.
McDonald's doesn't. Look at this.
No, hell no.
Look at this, they
have a machine already. They just put the cup there and it puts the ice and then fills the drink and then they just top it. Well, they don't manually fucking pour the drink anymore there.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
But yeah, they even have a line. So whenever I fill my drink, I go below the line for the ice. Okay, so we went to eat Vietnamese Cajun, and we got...
Did we get some last year? I think it was already done by the time I got back. Yeah, I got back in April.
Yeah, it was already done.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was already... I think... No, I don't remember. I don't think
no,
so.
No, we went.
Oh, we went, it was out of season.
We went, it was out of season. But
we still fucked up. So it was buy
we
five.
Go every year.
Yeah, it was buy five get one free. Pounds, $7.99 a pound. So that's 8 times 5. That's
You got one for free.
Yeah. But it was $40. Is that right? I'm gonna do my right.
$132.
$7.99 a pound.
Yeah.
8 times 5.
8 times 4, because we got one for free. So we only paid for 4.
No. You pay for 5 and you get 1 free, so it's 6 pounds.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Yeah, you get 6 pounds. Yeah. So it's $40 for 6 pounds. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, and it's good. And once again, with weight, $40 fish body, yeah, and the crawfish tails, it's kind of it's a
yeah.
But 6 pounds, right? Yeah, that's how everybody measures it. That's how we're gonna measure it. They were really good.
Yeah, they were.
I enjoyed it.
With the Cajun fried rice,
the potatoes. I fucking love the potatoes, man. The red potatoes. Yeah. They're so fucking good. Mm-hmm. And you make your little sauce.
Mm, that sauce. That miracle, it's trademark, folks. I can't give you the recipe.
You got business plans for it.
Yeah. It's gonna come out in the works, and you know, whenever I open up my Ragoon shop, you're gonna get some crawfish.
The YMD, the Yumi and Dice shop.
Yumi Dice. No, what?
Yumi Dice shop.
That's pretty good. Yumi Dice shop.
Yeah, the Yumi Dice shop.
And just fucking. That's our signature fucking dish. Yeah.
Well, I mean, our
crawfish
little,
ragoons, baby.
Our letter logos look like little atomic bombs.
They do.
Right?
They do. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Why? Yeah, they do, actually.
I was trying to find a way to make them look kind of cool. You know what? They could be a bottle, but the Y would have to be upside down.
Yeah. No, that's right, too.
So, I like this one.
So, we got... Six pounds, plus the rice, which feeds two.
And 6 potatoes.
And 6 potatoes. We ate that. And we looked at each other. And we're like, we can go for a little more. What are we thinking?
Well, here's the thing. Every time we go, we do a second round. I think there was one time we did a third round. Mm. One time. But we had gotten a smaller portion.
Well, yeah, we usually don't get the buy 5 get 1 free. We usually get the crawfish combo, which is 4 pounds.
Yeah. Yeah.
It gives you 4 pounds. So we do two of those, which is 8 pounds.
Yeah.
So today we doubled it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, double it, give it to the next person.
Yeah.
Essentially.
Yeah. Right.
So we did another 6 pounder. And I tapped out after, like, I was pretty much done.
You were, yeah.
I could feel it. I could see it in my soul. I couldn't do it. But it was good. It was great. We finished it up.
I was not tapped out.
Yeah, I can see that.
So in the morning, I had some cereal, right?
Mm-hmm.
I had 2 bowls of cereal in the morning. The idea was, like, I'm going to fill up so I don't need as much or whatever. I got there. We ate the first batch of crawfish, right? And then I was like, I need to make space.
Well, I ate the first batch of crawfish.
You ate the first
batch. You saw the fucking mountain. You're like, hold on, hold on. I'm going to just chill out.
You need to slow down.
Yeah. You're barred from these crawfish.
And, so I made some room in the bathroom, and I came back ready to go. I started eating again, and I was not getting full.
Mm.
I really wasn't. And we finished. I think there was like maybe 3 left.
Yeah.
It was like 3 left.
I think that's the whole point of crawfish, though. It's not supposed to make you full. Like, always, when I think about crawfish, right, it doesn't make you full. That's why you need your side dishes to fill you up.
Yeah.
And I feel like even if you just ate, like, let's say we just ate, like, what, 10 pounds of crawfish and no sides, nothing else, right? We wouldn't get full. And I think it's more like of a talking experience than a fucking eating experience, right?
Yeah.
Like it's that camaraderie, you know, of just sitting with someone and, you know, eating, devouring the fucking lives of all these crustaceans.
Yeah. But I want a few full.
Yeah.
You're suggesting... The only reason I stopped was because I was tired of chewing.
Yeah.
That's the only reason I stopped. I wasn't full. I was just tired of chewing.
Because
I still had some rice left, but I was like...
Mm.
I want to eat it to feel full, but I'm just tired. So it had nothing to do with being full. But it was good. It had some big ones. Not that many big ones.
Not that many, but it was still decent. Yeah.
I remember one time we just kept on getting some big
fucking lobsters.
Yeah.
Some fucking
big motherfuckers just back to back. That was a fun experience.
What if you had a last meal, you know, like death penalty and all that, what would it be? Would it include some crawfish in there? Or what would your last meal be?
Okay, so are we talking about like you're giving me a buffet spread, or am I able to choose one thing?
I'll give you like, we'll be
because I already know what it is.
Yeah. Five things. You get five things on the plate.
Okay.
Five things on the plate. Exactly.
I get five things on the table.
Or do you want a course? It can be a course. It can be you can have your appetizer, your entree with two sides, your super salad, right? And then your dessert.
Okay, so
with your beverage, two beverages. So a beverage course. And a cocktail.
So a course.
Okay, of course. I think that's okay. Good.
So I guess for the appetizer, fried pickles.
Fried pickles.
I love fried pickles. Okay. I fucking love fried pickles.
So ranch or no ranch?
Ranch.
You'd be like one of those fucking Boston bastards. Blue cheese.
Give me blue cheese.
Give me fungus.
So fried pickles all the way. Mm-hmm. I love them. They're delicious. I can't remember what place. I've had them from one place that they were fucking perfect. They were crisp, but the pickles was still like juicy.
Juicy.
It was fucking divine.
Do you think it's more of the breading that makes the difference?
100%.
Or the pickle?
The breading really makes a difference, right? Mm. If they have really good breading, I think it's a little bit of both. Mm. Like everything. It's a little bit of both. But the breading really... Because the pickle can be good, and the breading can suck. And so the fried pickle sucks ass.
Mm.
But if you have some really good breading on there, like some golden, like you got a fucking nugget in your hand.
So you like the whole surrounded breading, or you like crunchy bit breading?
Oh, fuck that crunchy bit breading. Oh,
okay.
Fuck so that
you
crunchy
know,
bit.
You know which one you... Yeah, you know which one. I don't know who makes them, but you've seen them. Those fucking little big ass chunks of fucking breading on the fucking fried pickles. It's like you try to bite into the pickle and it's just breading.
And it's just fucking... It shouldn't be called... They shouldn't be called fucking fried pickles. Yeah. It's in the fucking... It's an affront to the fried pickle community.
Yeah.
But I like the fried pickles with like just a nice coating of breading all the way around.
Mm.
Saltgrass, I think, makes them pretty good.
Yeah.
So that'll be my appetizer.
Okay. Just
a little bit of that. Dip on it.
So what drink?
Drink? Drink.
And you get two drinks. You get a cocktail drink and a regular beverage. So it can be a lemonade, a Coke, or whatever.
I would say if I were to tab. Get... Does the... What is the Long Island Iced Tea? What does that count as?
That's a cocktail.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to go with my new go-to now.
Okay.
Which is a Jack and Coke. Mm. A whiskey Coke.
Okay, so that's your cocktail.
Yeah.
Jack and Coke.
Yeah. Yeah. It used to be for a long time a Long Island Iced Tea.
So I want you to do this, okay? Whenever you have the time, go to Ward Market. Or Ward Market. Most likely Ward Market would have it. And look up Fentimen Cola. Fentimen. They have like a...
not associated with fentanyl?
No. Okay. Right. Curiosity Cola. It's more styled to the how Coca-Cola used to be, without the cocaine, of course, right? But it's an older version of Coke, you know.
Right.
It's not all this processed bullshit, you know, that Coca-Cola does. So do a Fentimen Cola with Jack or whatever fucking.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Jack. It's Jack and Coke, so do it with Jack. Whatever. Fuck it. That's what I would recommend. Do that.
Okay.
Whenever you have the chance. All
right.
World Market or
World Star.
Right. I mean, I'm sure there's other fucking places that do it, but it's a very niche Coke brand.
Okay.
Yeah. Because they do like sparkling, they do like a lot of mixers, like sparkling lemonades and all this stuff, but try them.
What's it called?
Fentimen.
Fentimen?
Yeah.
I'll write down on my notebook here. Fentimen. On World Market.
At least that's where I've seen them.
Right.
World Market.
Right. Online, I'm assuming.
Yeah. I mean, there's a World Market store right next to the Willowbrook.
I don't go down that way.
Well, I mean, there might be one over here. I'm not sure.
Right. I'm sure there's one.
If you can't find it there, just look to see who sells fentanyl.
Right. I'll just go to the local liquor store and be like, you guys got fentanyl?
Oh, my God.
So that would be my cocktail.
Okay.
As for main drink, this is tough. But I think I'm going to go with an agua de horchata. Like rice water with
salt. Horchata water.
Horchata, yeah. Agua de horchata.
Isn't it like sugary rice water?
Sugary rice water with cinnamon.
Okay.
And
I never liked it, by the way. I'm just...
Yeah.
I never liked agua de horchata or agua de tamarindo.
Oh, I love those, man.
Fuck those. Jamaica for life, boy.
I'm looking for life, that's it.
Yeah, no, I don't know. I don't know what the appeal is. I can't get down with the sickness, right?
Yeah.
But
I am
I do either limonada or fucking Jamaica.
Do you like all the melon?
I've had it. I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it.
I like it.
Piña is where it's at.
Oh, okay.
That shit's sweet. That shit's crack.
Yeah.
But okay, so your drink is agua de horchata,
mm-hmm.
fried pickles, Jack and Coke.
No, my meal.
Your meal.
No, when you said sides, are we talking about like, can I choose any sides?
Sure, man.
That fall into the sides category?
Sure.
Okay. I mean, my main meal is going to be flautas.
Okay.
Which for those of you who don't know, it's like, is you get chicken, shredded chicken that's been, you know, prepared with.
Why do people say rotisserie chicken won't work with that? Does it not really work with it?
It does work with it.
I think so too.
It's literally just chicken breasts.
Yeah.
The rotisserie chicken, you just shred it.
Shred it.
It's the same.
Like, nah.
You can do it.
I feel like that's the easy way to do it. Just buy a rotisserie chicken, shred it up.
It's the easy way to do it.
Fucking make flautas.
And what you can do is actually is to add some flavor to that chicken is you can put it in a saucepan with some salsa and just heat it together and then put that inside the tortilla, roll it up, fry it. You guys just love that.
So I know flautas are a Mexican thing, right? But
yeah.
I think the best flauta I've ever had was from a Salvadorian mom. Because she added cheese into it. I never knew. This never fucking... You know, me and my schmuck fucking mind never thought of it. It was like, cheese.
Yeah.
Cheese in a flauta. What the fuck?
Inside,
and
right?
Then, yeah, exactly. Inside, layered. So I took a bite and I'm like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah.
This is amazing. So I don't know if it's still considered a flauta. Damn,
but it had chicken in it, right?
Yeah, it was chicken. Yeah, it was a chicken one.
I think
I've like, never had it with cheese.
I think as long as it has some kind of meat inside, it's considered one, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it's just a fucking spring roll.
Okay. Oh, my God.
Egg roll, I mean. Okay. So it's that, you know, with all the fixings, you know, the sour cream. I like mine super, super simple. Sour cream that has been mixed with, they're called chiles en vinagre.
Mm-hmm.
Which is like jalapenos that have been put
pickled
in...
Pickled jalapenos,
that's basically. Mean,
yeah.
With salt, lime, and pepper.
Yeah.
Mix that with the sour cream.
Mm-hmm. Blend it?
Yeah. Oh, no. You just put the... You don't put the jalapeno in there.
Mm-hmm.
Just the liquid. Just the vinegar.
Oh, shit. My mom actually puts the...
Yeah.
My mom puts the jalapenos in there. Yeah. And then puts cream cheese, sour cream, salt, pepper, limon, and blends it.
Yeah.
That shit comes out. Ooh.
For me, it's a lot easier when to just and then with some Parmesan cheese on top.
Parmesan cheese.
Yeah,
I like repollo with them. Yeah.
Yeah, so do I.
I like putting like
which not is lettuce, fucking cabbage.
Cabbage. Yeah, not fuck lettuce.
I like it, but there's the simplicity about
that. As long as it's dry cabbage. I mean, wet it, you know, right? But then pat it dry. Or right. I don't want fucking wet flautas.
Yeah.
Okay, so flautas. Okay, that's your side. I mean, that's your fucking entree.
Right. So the side is two sides?
Yeah, two sides.
Two sides. I'll go with a... I mean, I love me a good chicken tortilla soup.
Well, you still have your soup. That's separate. You still have your soup.
Oh, my soup is separate.
Yeah, super salad. That's separate from your sides.
Oh. Okay, well, for the super salad, this chicken tortilla soup. But I'm not talking about, I'm talking about like actual tortillas in the fucking soup.
Yeah.
Not fucking the crunchy fucking shit.
Bits. Yeah.
Yeah. So chicken tortilla soup with actual fucking tortillas in it.
Mm-hmm.
Sides.
With a dollop of sour cream. Have you ever?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God. Sides. We just ate, by the way.
Yeah.
So it hurts to think about this.
Sides, I would say, I mean, I love me some broccoli and butter. Just so, you put like broccoli.
So you steam your broccoli?
Steam it, boil it.
I saute mine.
Saute?
Yeah, so I get a little bit of oil and saute it. Usually I would, it's very Asian, right? But I do soy sauce and like red peppers.
Oh,
okay. Red pepper flakes with like salt, pepper, and sauteed.
Is it the crunch?
I like the not the crunch, but whenever it blackens a little bit, I like that flavor profile that charness.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I mean, of course you have to blanch it. You blanch it for like a minute, like in boiling water. Then you take it out and then saute it.
Okay.
It's a little extra step, but it really makes that difference. And then, but I assume you do it with butter then.
Yeah, because when you steam it and you put butter, it becomes like this juicy piece of like broccoli.
Yeah.
So I'll be one side.
That's one side, okay.
The other side, maybe some shrimp fried rice.
We always talk about it.
Some shrimp
fried rice. We always talk about it. And yes, it has to be.
Some shrimp fried rice, but and with the long the bean sprouts.
Uh-huh.
With bean sprouts. Lots of bean sprouts.
Yes. They have, and since it's my last meal, it has to be cooked by shrimp.
I mean, but there's the only ones who cook it. Yeah. No one else cook. The only ones that can cook shrimp fried rice are shrimps. That's why it's called shrimp fried rice.
It's fried rice made by shrimp.
Yeah.
I don't need actual shrimps in there.
Yeah.
That would be a weird ritual that they would do if they added shrimps into their own fucking... Yeah, that's weird.
That's weird.
It's regular fried rice made by shrimp.
Made by shrimp. I don't see what the problem is.
Just add eggs, you know, peas and fucking carrots and let's go.
Gotta have my bean sprouts.
Bean sprouts.
Gotta have my bean sprouts.
I've never had it with bean sprouts. I don't think I've had it with bean sprouts.
I've had it at like the Mambo's and stuff like that. They do bean sprouts.
Oh, they do. You're right.
Because they give that little crunch.
Yeah, it does.
Ooh. Mm. So that would be my other side.
Okay.
Dessert.
And that's not bad because it still goes with flautas.
Yeah. That's why I
want... Usually it's Mexican rice.
That's usually it's Mexican rice, but I wanted that like... I already got my Mexican in the flautas and the horchata, so I want a little bit of something
else. Okay.
For dessert?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go with something I always enjoy, which is chocolate lava cake.
When were you... okay, maybe too personal. The year I was born, was the cake of the year.
Oh, okay.
Chocolate lava cakes.
Then that would be the same for me.
I assume so. I didn't want to assume. Okay, I didn't want to assume.
I can tell you this: the first time I had a chocolate lava cake was I went on a date with a girlfriend of mine during high school.
Yeah,
we went to Chili's,
mm-hmm.
and she would always order the same thing, which was at the time it was really annoying.
What was that? What was that dish?
The chicken crispers, the honey chicken crispers. Always.
I don't like them.
Always.
I don't like... I have an aversion to tenders of crisp of chicken.
It's hit or miss with them.
Yeah, I'll eat them, but I'm like, fuck. Yeah. There's so many better fucking dishes.
Yeah.
Right?
She would always get that, because it was part of the 2 for 20.
It was.
Yeah.
I would always get the Cajun chicken pasta.
I would always mix it up.
Okay.
I mean, it's 2 for 20, no?
Yeah.
That's the first time I had it.
And then they made it to 2 for 25. Fuck them when they did that.
Yeah. I mean, everything's got to go up, right?
I mean, they don't even happen anymore.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, there you go. It's gone.
But that's the same girlfriend who, when I had a steak at Chili's, the first time I ever had a
steak.
What could be considered a steak, she judged me because she's like, this is an estate. And I was like, I'm sorry I didn't grow up rich, bitch.
So...
But that would be a chocolate lava cake.
I've had a ribeye steak from Chili's too. And it gives me almost a vibe of like a pork chop more than a steak. Like the aftertaste is very pork chop like.
Could be that it's pork.
I don't know. I'm sure it's beef. But like I don't know. Like I guess the way they almost like they put oil and fry it. I don't know.
I had a really good T-bone steak one time in this small town in New York. The state, not the city. I was traveling for work and me and this guy I were with. I was like, let's get whatever you want. He was like, are you sure, man? I'm like, don't worry about it. I'm paying. They're paying me good for that job. Yeah. And we got like some big fucking steaks and some drinks. It was nice. It was during the Pokemon Go thing that summer. So I never got into Pokemon Go.
Yeah.
Every time there was like a fucking
event
or quote unquote,
I was never strong enough to get into Pokemon Go.
I'm never around for like these fads.
Yeah,
never. I'm always in a fucking different country, or too busy working. It's all like it just the whole Vine thing.
Mm-hmm.
I never...
Yeah, the 7 seconds fucking... No. Even TikTok. I missed that one too.
Vine and the thing is, TikTok is still around.
Yeah, but it's not like... Okay, so I guess they're called Reels, right? So yeah. TikToks, Instagram Reels.
Oh, all that stuff. Facebook, well, I'm saying like... whatever. Like these events, right? Because yeah. Vine went away, right?
Yeah, they did.
But that in that period that it was around... I was busy doing other things that I couldn't get it. I wasn't able to get into it.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, hey, yeah, Vine. But I couldn't like just. There's people who have like this memory of that era, of that time period. And I have nothing. I have something completely.
Everything's a blur for me.
Yeah. It's. I mean, I find it very interesting.
Yeah.
But.
So
yeah, that's my And the chocolate lava cake, because I just. Ever since I had had it that first time, I've always loved it. That cold and warm juxtaposition.
Yes.
It was just so good.
They always, for me, I'm always more of an ice cream man, so I need a little bit more ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know if you've been to House Pies.
I haven't, but okay. There's actually one.
In the Woodlands.
Yeah.
There's one in the Woodlands. So they have a brownie sundae. Probably one of the best brownie sundaes I've ever had. Probably like bar none, like one of the best ones I've had. And I've had a lot of chocolate ice cream fucking dessert like things. Right, so it's almost like a chocolate lava cake, right? Because it's a hot brownie, right?
Oh
it's
yeah,
steaming
yeah.
Hot.
I fucking love a good brownie, man. God,
with still fudgy in the middle. Oh, fuck me, right? Man. And then they a la mode it with fucking whipped cream and the whole shebang, right? Chocolate. Oh, the worst one I've had. Which, fuck you for calling that sundae, was, I think it's called, like, Mellow Pizza? Mellow's Pizza?
You've heard of it.
It's, like, hippie sort of fucking, whatever. They fucking suck. Like, I did not have a good experience with them. So, you know, I went with the dog, I went with the dog, and so we had to sit outside because.
Okay.
You know,
the dog.
Yeah, exactly. So, they bring a dog bowl for him at least. You know, very nice, right?
Right.
But, I put in my review because I had to, that, the dog got better service than we did. They did. It really did. So. We waited like fucking forever for a shit.
Oh my god.
And then I ordered an Arnold Palmer, right?
Right.
And they're like, okay, yeah, we can do it. Yeah. And I'm like, okay, cool. Thanks. You know, like, okay, thank you, Arnold Palmer. And they bring me two cups, one with iced tea and one with lemonade. And it's not even lemonade, it's the fucking Minute Maid lemonade.
Oh no.
And it was hot iced tea that they fucking yeah, dude. So I had to mix my own fucking cup of Arnold Palmer. Because I got a Sprite first. I remember that. I got a Sprite first and it had no fucking fizz.
Oh no, it was just a flat.
No, I'm sorry. It was carbonated but had no syrup. So it was.
So they brought you like carbonated
mineral water. Exactly. Fucking just. So I'm like, okay, no, fuck this. Give me a, you know,
Arnold Palmer. And then they just like.
And then they bring me that thing. I'm like.
They're like, they went to the back and like, what is an Arnold Palmer?
Yeah.
And they're like, weird. And then they just, I guess you want like, some hot tea.
Well, you're a fucking in Texas. It's an Arnold Palmer. And then so.
Animals are everywhere.
And then we ordered the pizza. The pizza was like subpar.
Yeah.
Really was, right? Yeah, we just got the meat lovers, whatever.
Right.
Subpar. And then we're like, okay. We're gonna finish strong, hopefully. Let's get that brownie sundae. Oh, the it was a sad fucking sundae. It was I don't know if you can call this a brownie, really. It was a scrap. The scrap of a husk of a fucking brownie. And with like just a dollop of an ice cream. No whipped cream, no cherry, no nothing. Just that's it. No presentation. So we're like, man, fuck this place. And it was like $9, bro, for the fucking brownie sundae. And
was it somewhere in Houston?
Yes.
I had a feeling, yeah.
So I had a feeling. Yeah, it was garbage. So I left. I mean we paid, right?
Right. You're not an animal.
Or did we? No, yeah, we did. We did pay. But we shouldn't have.
You should. They didn't deserve it.
Yeah. Cool. So, chocolate molten lava cake. That's your final meal.
Mm-hmm.
You eat all that. You go into the...
It reminds me of sex.
Yeah. And then you go into the abyss. How? What? How? What?
Yeah.
How does that do that? The chocolate lava cake reminds you of sex. So, like, when you want to get her into the mood...
No, because that day we had sex later on.
Oh, it brings back memories of
it
sex.
But it's
tied to that event.
Yeah, because it was supposed to be like a romantic-ish date or whatever. I think her parents were out of town. So after we had the dinner or whatever, went to over to her house because her parents were gone.
Mm-hmm.
And then we fucked like rabbits.
Mm.
Yeah. So that's what it reminds me. It reminds me of like warm vagina. In a good way. In a good way. Like, I don't like it because of that.
I guess I can taste
it. I like it because of the, like I said, the juxtaposition between the cold ice cream and the hot brownie.
Okay.
But it always reminds me of sex.
So.
Every single time.
So, when you finish eating this meal, you're about to fade into the abyss and you bust. That's what you're saying?
Yeah. So, okay. I chose that so that, like. Because it's my final meal, and I finish off, they can't kill me because I'm already dead.
Yeah. All right.
They're like, don't touch him, he's coming.
All right. Now I gotta think. For mine. All right.
Go ahead.
Son of a bitch. Okay, so I would go for my two drinks.
Mm-hmm.
First one, Dr. Pepper. I'm texting till I die.
All right, yeah.
Stock
the
pepper. Wake up, baby. Yeah, I just fucking, I don't know.
The Waco shooting?
No, what? No, Waco is where Dr. Pepper was.
I know.
You son of a bitch.
I'm fucking with you.
Sure, the Waco shooting. Rip. Spoiler alert. There is a shooting in Waco.
Yeah, a long time ago. Big famous one.
Yeah. Okay, so.
It was a cult, wasn't it? I think it was a cult.
Possibly.
Yeah, I think it was a cult.
Possibly. Okay. But they're not always... They're like fucking boring cults at that. They're not even like Yog-Sothoth fucking cults, right? We're like...
I mean, you got... Highly mystical the fucking beings. The problem is you need to have creativity to have a cool cult.
Yeah.
Right? Because you... The cults that we see, it's like these fucking losers. Okay, so here's a cult. The Church of Scientology.
Mm-hmm.
They have a lot of like really weird shit that they do that makes them a cool cult. You don't want to join them, like you don't want to join any kind of fucking cult.
Yeah.
But in terms of cool cults, I think Scientology is at the top.
Yeah, they drain your bank accounts.
Yeah. I mean, they've got the creativity. Okay, so...
Okay,
Dr. Pepper.
My second one, which is the cocktail. Fuck, that's hard.
You're a cocktail master.
I am.
You're a cockmaster.
I'm a cockmaster. God damn it. no, I'm an enthusiast, right? But It's narrowed down to between a like just a perfect original margarita. It's everything you need, right?
Yeah.
It's either that. So I have to decide between a margarita, an aviation, and a gin and ginger mojito.
Now here's the question: how big is a margarita? I tell about like those places where they're like, yeah,
no, $2 margaritas. Fuck you. Fucking... No, it's a fucking max like 4 ounces.
Max.
It's like the same as a fucking Jack and Coke. It's small. Nothing fucking. And I don't want it in a fucking margarita glass. I hate those glasses. No, give me like the same glass you would use for like an old fashioned or something, right?
A quote unquote enthusiast, you're more like a fanatic.
Mm.
And I don't like fanatics.
So again, a margarita, right? We'll teach you the recipe here right now. Very quickly. You ready?
Go for it.
All right. Well, it really depends on what tequila you like, right? I'm a fan of Don Julio. Mm-hmm. So I use Don Julio. 2 ounces. You can either go Blanco or Reposado. I do not judge either. Both are very good. So you 2 ounces, right?
Mm-hmm.
You do 1 ounce of lime juice.
Mm-hmm.
You do 1 ounce of Cointreau. I think I might be butchering that, but it's a orange liqueur. A lot of people call it triple sec, but you know, if you look at most any fucking margarita recipe, they're always going to count for that specific one, Cointreau. It's French. So use that one, 1 ounce. So it's 1-1-2. So usually it's a 2-1-1. That's usually what they call. With ice, shake it for like 8 to 10 seconds. And then put in your glass. Hopefully your rim is salted or sugared. Either way, I prefer salted because, you know, salt brings out natural flavors, right? It's just that umami. And then with a lime wedge. That's it. That's your beautiful fucking margarita.
I feel like you already have your choice.
Yeah, okay, it's margarita. It's margarita.
Yeah, I think...
Because the other ones are just too hard to make. not that they're hard, but it's the same fucking... So, okay, Dr. Pepper, margarita, 2 drinks.
Also, I'm assuming we're in prison for murder. That's in my mind. Or are we just like, God has come down from the heavens and you're like, eat your last meal.
No,
you're gonna die.
No, it's I'm probably like
your soul.
Yeah, it's some heinous act, right? Like,
right.
It would have to be. It would have to be. I'm not gonna go to fucking prison and have my last meal for a fucking parking ticket, right? It has to be a heinous act that I would. Right. I
but not too heinous where they're not winning to go. You know.
What is the farthest you feel like you can go down that fucking hole, right? Are you going to be, like, do you feel like you can, you're looking at me with a fucking Adolf Hitler mustache right now. Is that how far you think you can go?
Like, you're asking me if I had the power to go deep
into this. I'm not necessarily power.
I'm not talking about, like, superpower. Yeah, I'm talking about, like, political power.
I'm not even talking about political power. I'm talking about, like, if I turned on the news tomorrow.
Yeah.
What is the most heinous thing that you think you are capable of? And be like, a man found so-and-so-so or whatever, right?
Yeah. I would say... I probably wouldn't live through it.
Okay.
I'm just saying that, like, I feel like I would go into...
You never know, Gary. You never know.
No, man. Sometimes you know. First, I just couldn't do anything.
By the way, let's not say anything that's going to incriminate us.
Well, first, I wouldn't be able to do anything, like, bad to innocent people.
Okay.
Like, I just can't. So, it would have to be, like, what the hell? What's a good number? These
8 politicians, 8 oil.
Okay. Oh, okay. So we're gonna go that route.
Or what are you more like?
I was gonna say like 18.
18.
Like 18 bad people.
Okay. Oh, Jesus. Okay. The more the merrier, I suppose.
I mean, you said how heinous, and like, I'm just trying to like limit myself.
would you target specific
let's say I would target, oh god, this is gonna sound so bad. the politicians.
Hypothetically, this is all hypothetical.
Oh, hypothetically. The politicians, the FBI agent who's assigned to us, is like, get a pen and paper.
This is all in Minecraft.
In Minecraft. I would find the Minecraft politicians.
Yeah. You have to say, oh, and this is all in Minecraft.
Oh, this is all in Minecraft.
At the end of it. I get to scot free.
Just, you know, all the politicians who have put themselves and money first over the well-being of the people of this nation or of the world, I'd find the worst ones of those and I'd cut them down. And anybody who stood in my way would get cut down too. So I guess I would do some bad stuff in Minecraft.
Yeah, I can see that. A lot of TNT blocks.
A lot of TNT. So that's kind of what I'm thinking. Like, I feel like
That's going to be your name. You're going to be, the Creeper.
The Creeper, yeah.
Yeah, you're going to be the Creeper.
I mean, it's in Minecraft, so.
It's Minecraft.
Well, it's Steve, actually.
Yeah, Steve.
So that's, if you're to turn on the news on Minecraft CNN, on MNN, Minecraft News Network,
yeah,
you would see that Steve has gone on a rampage and killed 18 politicians, as well as the bodyguards who were defending them.
Mm-hmm.
And wives who thought they could stand in the way of a bullet.
Okay.
A Minecraft bullet.
Yeah, Minecraft arrow.
A Minecraft arrow. I feel like that's what you would see. And then they'd be like, oh man, we should put him in jail. Because he killed 30 plus people.
Yeah.
Because the number would have gone up in Minecraft.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Because you would have gone from 18 villager politicians.
So it would have to be a meeting. These 18 individuals.
No.
Or would you hunt each?
I would take a span of 10 hours in Minecraft.
Mm-hmm.
And then just like, I mean, it would be premeditated. Yeah. Everything, right?
Everything.
It would be like, find their Minecraft schedules.
Mm-hmm.
See what time they're online.
Their Minecraft ledgers.
Yeah. See the path of least resistance, and move like a fucking knife through butter through these horrible politicians that are ruining the Minecraft world. So you would turn on the news and be like, Steve has just gone on a rampage and killed 30 people, 18 of those who are politicians
in Minecraft. Yeah.
And then you would be like,
watch all these politicians playing Minecraft and now they're scared of their character being dead. Yeah.
Well, it's in Minecraft. So
yeah, it's in Minecraft, yeah.
So you would turn on the news and be like,
now you're in Minecraft, Joe.
Okay. This seems super. I know his last meal now.
I feel like for me, it would have to be something to along the effects of, I don't know if you remember the gentleman that tore down a couple buildings with that bulldozer, that Rhino made, that tank. He essentially made a tank out of a fucking, out of construction equipment.
Yeah.
And, you know, modified it. It would be something along the lines of that.
Okay. What would you be demolishing?
Government.
It seems like the theme here.
Not government, right? It's more like well, it is government, but like maybe banking or something along the lines of IRS, that kind of thing.
Yeah. I feel like the government of Minecraft is not good.
Central Minecraft Banking.
Jump for stealing the U.S. Constitution.
The U.S. Constitution.
The Declaration of Independence.
And going on a mission.
Okay, all right. So it seems like.
Of course, people are in the way. I'm sorry.
Right. You have an objective, and that is to make a statement, to send a message to the world that you're no longer to be trifled with, and they need to stay away from you.
Not even trifled with. It's just like, You pushed people so far, right?
Yeah.
What do you have left to lose?
Okay. I was thinking just like something snaps.
Mm.
For me, that's what it would be.
Something
in
snaps.
In Minecraft.
Yeah, in Minecraft.
It's like something would snap, and then it's like, I'm fucking tired of these fucking animals.
Yeah, you got nothing left to lose.
You're just done, I gotta go like, Yeah.
So, okay, last meal. Let's get back to it. Mm-hmm. Hey.
We never left.
Yeah.
So death row, you just fucking mowed down fucking people.
By the way, they don't give you last meal. Well, they do, but you don't get your pick anymore.
No, I think it's like what's in the kitchen.
Yeah, they changed it up. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're living in a fantasy world called Minecraft, so you're getting your last meal.
Okay, cool. Dr. Pepper,
margarita. Dr. Pepper, margarita.
We're going on to appetizers. Crab raccoons.
There's a moment where I thought you were going to think about it.
No. Nope.
And then you didn't.
I didn't have to.
You had it decided already.
I didn't have to. A perfect crab raccoon. Like.
Perfect crab raccoon.
Like actual crab, cream cheese, beautiful.
It goes a long way. It goes a very long way.
Fuck. I can, like, devour many of those. Mm-hmm. But, you know. Not, I wouldn't eat too much of them.
Right. You can't. You want to lose space.
Too much decadence.
Right.
Crab ragoons would be my appetizer. Mm-hmm. Entree. I love red meat, man. What can I say? Mm-hmm. And I know it's a classic and a lot of people pick it right, but I would get probably maybe a 16-ounce ribeye steak. Probably wouldn't finish it all.
Right.
But, you know, I would want prime. I wouldn't even want Wagyu, right? Because it's too...
It's too much fat.
Fucking...
It makes you feel a little
sick. I would want prime. Prime ribeye steak. I don't care if they give it to me bone in or bone out, right? But...
Right. As long as the 16 ounce comes from the meat.
Yep, exactly. Medium rare.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe medium. With some Worcester sauce. I'm a fan of Worcester sauce.
Really?
Yeah, with my steak.
Really?
Yeah.
You're fucking with me, right?
No, I like it. So, like, I do a little dip.
Oh, okay.
Fucking pour it on my steak.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, well, I was about to... I was going to be a list of 19.
No. No, you fucking... You dip it. You dip a little bit of Worcester in the Worcester. You don't fucking...
Okay.
You don't pour it onto your perfect steak.
Right.
Oh, with some compound butter.
Mm-hmm.
Just let it go, baby. That's my entree. My two sides. I cannot live without a potato side. I need a potato side.
I think I've noticed that's kind of like
it's meat and potatoes.
It's literally the meat and potatoes of meat and potatoes.
It's chicken and rice.
Yeah.
Fuck chicken and rice enthusiasts. I'm a meat and potato enjoyer.
Okay. Right? Fuck you, beta cucks.
And what did you go with? Chicken and rice, bastard. You rat bastard. No, it's meat and potatoes. It's the same logic. So, now the potatoes.
What kind of potato?
Yukon Gold.
Okay.
Whipped.
Mmm.
I would want to make my own potatoes, by the way. Fuck you, don't. Yeah. I want to fucking boil my potatoes, pass them through the tammy, whip them, put them in that pipe bag, pipe it. I mean, of course, with butter. Right. Good butter, by the way, for like French butter. Parsley,
I said salt, handmade pepper. Fucking butter.
Yeah. Yeah. Fucking handmade butter. It already has like some herbs in there.
Yeah.
And then parsley, salt, and pepper, baby. That's my dish right there. That's my first entree. My second entree, that's hard. Second entree would probably have to be damn. See, I think about it too, right? Like, it's my last meal, so I can fucking, like, who cares if it's healthy or not, right? But even at that point, like, that human part of me is like, you're going to regret it in the morning. You're going to regret it in the morning. You're going to die in the next hour, but you're going to regret it in the morning. Oh, fuck that. I would go, like, with a really good, like, some sort of mac and cheese. Like, maybe even, like, baked or a slow cooker mac and cheese.
I've heard of, don't they do, like, loaded mac and cheese? Would they put like bacon bits on it?
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Or like bacon tips on it.
But I wouldn't want all that.
You would want the simple mac and cheese.
Give me that Kraft mac and cheese. No, fuck
delicious that.
Delicious
cheese powder.
No. Like, I love when they do it in slow cookers. They do like five cheeses and like cream and salt, pepper, paprika. Put your elbow or your macaroni noodles and then just slow cook it for like 4 or 6 hours.
Okay.
I've made it. It's beautiful. But like, that's the way I would want it, right? Or baked, whenever mm-hmm. they bake it too, and it has that crust.
That crust, yeah,
beautiful top crust. Yeah. So that's my dish. It's very basic, but I'm a basic bitch. What can I say?
Sure, Mr. Handmade Butter. And
I mean, look, no. Okay, so we'll go to that now. Even if the dish is basic, I want the best way to make it and the best ingredients.
Okay.
Right? I don't want Kraft mac and cheese. I don't want fucking, like, instant fucking mashed potatoes. And I don't want fucking Walmart steak.
Right.
I want the best way that they can find it, right?
Okay.
The best butter from France, you know, that they fucking make it. And the fact, well, it's still in a factory, but you haven't seen those videos?
Yeah, I've seen them when they hit with the mallet and all that stuff.
Beautiful.
I love those videos.
Yeah. Mm. So. And then for my dessert,
No, we already know that you say you like ice cream.
I do like ice cream.
So
I'm not gonna. I like chocolate lava cake too. But I feel like for me, it would have to be. I have to decide between one of the two desserts that I've only had in my life, right? Well, I've had multiple desserts in my life, but the ones that are like that stood out to me the most were a peach and a cobbler from Salt Lick Barbecue.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful fucking cobbler. It was like berry and peach, I think.
Mm.
It was like a mix of two, and then they added those a la mode. Beautiful. It was one of the best cobblers I've ever had. So it would either be that, or it would be a strawberry rhubarb pie a la mode. Just a slice. I don't even need the full pie. Ooh! Or that fucking apple pie. It's very... So the HEB one that we got here was very close to the one that I remember from eons ago, right? From like 10 years ago from Thanksgiving. Very close. That's pretty much what it was. Almost like a la mode. It would have to have ice cream.
Right.
So I think if I had to pick between those three, it'd probably be the strawberry rhubarb. Strawberry rhubarb.
You gotta go with the one that reminds you of sex.
Yeah. Okay. Strawberry rhubarb. It's like the Red Seas.
Mm.
It's red like the Red Seas.
Yeah.
Poor bastard. So that would be my final meal.
All right. I respect it.
It's very American.
It is. You know, for me, I was going more for like. I wasn't trying to make a coherent meal.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like from.
I know what you mean, and I wasn't either. But it sounds like a fucking.
It's not like a very coherent
meal. Yeah. It worked. Oh shit! My soup.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. I'm assuming not a salad.
You assumed right. With the white chicks, he's like, perhaps a salad, perhaps not. you assumed correctly. Not a salad. It would have to be a soup. I know this is too much for me, right? But I think like a caldo de pollo. No, caldo de res. Caldo de res. Oh no, power. I'm already having meat. Probably pollo. Caldo de pollo. Mm-hmm. But like super, like, you know, fucking Mexican.
Right? Like super fucking rich.
Yeah,
and
super flavored Mexican.
And like the fucking... Well, it's because it got the corn. It's got the fucking potatoes in there. Mm-hmm.
Got the squash.
Some squash, yeah.
Or zucchini.
Zucchini. It's got a lot of good stuff.
Okay, carrots. Yeah. Chicken. No bones.
Nice.
They've deboned it for me.
Now here's the question. Do you take some tortillas, roll them up, and dip them into the soup?
And then you have some arroz at the bottom, too.
Okay, yeah.
Boy.
That's good.
A little bit of limon.
And I should have gone for a pozole.
How you with that? I mean, it's a good soup, right?
No, I like it. Chicken tortilla soup, wherever it is I go, I always, if they have the chicken tortilla soup, I'll always take it.
Yeah, I'll take
it. It's just something about that fucking, it's just, honestly, it's the tortilla that makes it for me.
Mm.
It's the tortilla that just fucking,
why can't I have fucking fried tortilla in my regular caldo de pollo? It's the same shit. It will make it a chicken tortilla soup.
Yeah.
Yeah, it will be a chicken. Yeah. Fucking chicken tortilla soup, but it's a caldo de pollo.
Yeah,
a soup of chicken.
Soup of chicken.
That's what it's called in English. Soup of chicken. That's my meal.
That's your meal.
That's my meal.
I mean, yeah, it's a good meal.
Mm.
It's a good meal. And then afterwards, what execution style?
Hmm.
Like not.
Call me old fashioned.
I'm gonna go with
fire range.
Oh, okay. That's kind of cool.
That's the only way to go.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to be hanged. I get it. It's going to be painful still, firing range. But they still give you the cigar, so. Yeah. Or the cigarette. Yeah. At least, hopefully.
I mean, and it's also sounds cool, though, right? Like when you
very dictatorship, isn't it?
Yeah, like, oh... Yeah, Tommy was executed.
What the fuck?
Firing squad. Oh shit!
That motherfucker got
it. He got a firing squad? Because you hear like lethal injection. I was like, oh god, lethal injection.
Boy.
Much more peaceful, but oh god, lethal injection. You hear electric chair, like, god damn.
They hated that motherfucker.
Yeah. You say, hanged, and I'm like, did his neck break? Like, no.
Yeah,
he suffered.
He suffered like a poor bastard.
He was 30 minutes.
Choking on this fucking, that fucking meal that he ate.
Guillotine. And what do you think?
Guillotine?
I mean, it's a slice.
Yeah, it's just dead. It's not dead. It's like 8 seconds, but like you don't feel seconds. It.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would think, I would go with guillotine.
God, guillotine. You're not a fucking, I guess. I mean, I feel like guillotines are tied to like nobility and like fucking, you know, it's the vice versa. It's the rich and the government killing you when it should be civilian doing that to the government
or royalty. Well, here's the thing.
It's vice versa.
In Minecraft, I already killed a bunch of politicians, right? So they're like, oh, we're going to get back at him. But all they're doing is fueling the flames of a revolution, baby. They're going to see...
The Minecraft Revolution?
The Minecraft Revolution, yeah. It's a mod.
Stand up, my fellow... My fellow
Minecraftians.
Yeah, my fellow Steves and Creepers.
Because it's like, oh shit, what did they do to Steve? Yeah, they fucking put him to the guillotine.
So you would not want to be hanged and quartered?
No. No. I think Firing Squad really does sound cool.
Yeah.
But I would, like... I feel like... For the guillotine, it's like they're gonna tell people to come see, right? Like come
spectacle.
See. It's gonna be a spectacle.
No, I want me in some fucking back alley, like
some dirty ass fucking dingy back alley, and some
put me to a wall.
Yeah,
put the cigarette, bend, fucking tie me up.
Yeah, that's a way to go.
They don't even give me a signal.
Yeah,
nothing.
They just,
I just hear the shots and that.
Yeah.
Hopefully, they're good marksmen. By the way.
Yeah.
You know. Some go for the. I don't even care if you go for the head.
Yeah.
Just go for the killing blows.
Yeah. yeah, I think guillotine.
And then just bury me in a shallow grave.
Yeah. Throw you in with the rest of the. Rabble.
Rest of the Minecraftians.
Yeah, the rest of the Minecraftians. It's all been in Minecraft.
Yeah.
But I think that would be for me. I think the I think the execution style. Needs to match sort of the what brought it on.
Mm. Right?
Like in Minecraft, I went on and killed a bunch of politicians because I was tired of the political rule on the villagers and everything. So when they're like, oh, this is what happens, they're not...
I'm surprised neither of us said crawfish for our last meal.
I mean, I have it once a year.
Mm.
Or twice a year.
Oh, and that's the most you can do.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
But I mean, I do a lot, right?
Yeah. You down a small child,
pretty much. So I feel like it has to meet the.
I get you.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I would probably. Okay. Cool. I think that works, right? That's our final meal talk. Mm-hmm. One of the other subjects I wanted to get into. As you stated before, you like to write, right?
I do.
So, what is your, do you feel like you've made your own writing style? Or have you gotten influence from other writers?
Initially, I was drawing influence from others.
Okay.
I mean, that's kind of what they say it is, right?
Yes.
Yeah. It's
your forefathers.
Your forefathers. They say more like you mimic other writers until you find your own voice.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a lot of incomplete works where I was mimicking other writers. And I liked the stories I was trying to write, mm-hmm. but it just didn't feel right, you know? Yeah. Recently, I started this one story, and it feels good.
Okay.
Like, it feels like it's my voice.
Mm.
Like, it feels like it's me telling the story. As opposed to me trying to sound like somebody else telling the story, which is what all of the other ones sound like, right? Mm. Which means that this story is going to be very sad.
Okay.
My idea for the story, I'm not going to go into the details of the plot or everything, but I'm going to take inspiration from like my own issues
mm-hmm.
and obstacles I faced throughout my youth in my life. I'm going to transpose it onto that, make them a little bit more different, and sort of delve more into certain themes, right?
I don't know if you know, we have a schoolmate. That's also a writer. I would have to look him up on Facebook again. He's a teacher right now, but he did some writing. And I think he won. I think his poem was featured in a it was featured or won first or we I think won first and won second, in like a competition recently. Like as an adult, not like this is school writing, right?
Right.
This is like him like putting in his word, right? So I was like, I thought that was interesting.
Yeah.
I'll show you. Hopefully, I'll have the chance to show you, and I can get your thoughts on that as a writer. But, okay, so you feel like you have your own writing style, right?
Yeah.
So, I like that topic of like, you know, like, you're like, okay, so what is your target demographic? Like, who are you writing for? Are you writing for the kid that doesn't really have, like, those people in their lives? Or are you writing for, like, an adult that's going through hard times? Or, like, are you writing a children's thing? Like, what are you trying to reach? Who are you trying to give this story to, right? Because you have to think about it, even, like, logistically, right? Like, they tell you, like, when you're trying to sell a book, who are you writing to? Who is this targeted to?
Yeah.
All right. So what do you feel like that is?
Well, I would say, I'll give you two. Not thinking about it in terms of marketing. I want to write for those who can read.
For those who can read.
Yeah. I mean, who are of age as well, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want some 5-year-old kid.
So you mean, but you mean like those who can read, like, that's very general, right? Just know how to read, or those that like understand the topic of what they're reading?
Those who know how to read. If you're able to read English letters?
Yeah, you can read, words? But like, what I mean is like, understanding, like a lot of people, like, essentially reading between the lines, right? Understanding what the author is trying to
explain. Yeah.
Is that what you mean, or is it you're just, I'm just writing to someone that can read?
Someone who can read.
Mm.
It's, I want it to be out there. The thing is, I understand the idea behind wanting to, like, write a very dense novel where you need to be really smart and like socially and be able to read between the lines, that narrows down the reach of who can read your story.
Mm.
And I mentioned it before, where I want to entertain people.
Okay.
And I don't want my fucking ego to be the reason why somebody can't enjoy a story.
Mm.
If that makes sense, right? Because I've met writers who are their ego is just like, they just believe themselves to be above everybody else. And be like, well, it's like, they want it, like elitist, sort of, to a degree. And if anything that isn't to that level of their
standard,
then it's beneath them, and it's like, and it isn't, should it be considered literature?
Okay,
I consider those people fools. I mean, it's just it's narrow-minded, really.
Mm.
So when I write the story that I'm writing, I want people who can read to read it.
Mm.
That is the target.
Find enjoyment.
Read this story. Because I think what I'm trying to do is that, depending on what stage in your life you read it, it's going to be different, right? Because you can read it, let's say you're 13 years old, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you read it and you're like, depending on how hard your life has been as a 13-year-old, you can be like, this is a good story. Like, it's fun. It has action and all that stuff. Some of the stuff I don't really understand. Right. Mm. It could go over their head, right? But they still enjoy it.
Yeah.
Maybe they get that same person gets older, maybe in their early mid 20s. They're like, oh man, yeah, this is like getting a bit more close to home now, right? Mm-hmm. Then you get older, much older, and you're like, huh, like I recognize this person as someone I used to be.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of what I want to do. So if somebody were to ask me, oh, for marketing purposes, what demographic are you trying to reach? I would say young adult. Young adult to like early 20s, the primary one. Mm. Because the way I have this idea of the story planned out is like stages in life of this character.
Mm-hmm.
If it will ever publish, I do not know, but I want to write it.
Yeah.
And that's what's really important for me, to be able to write it. If I can publish it, great. But I want to write it so that if I can't publish it, anybody can read it.
Yeah.
I don't want it to be restricted. And this is the other part where like I'm a bit, it's a bit difficult. I don't want money to be the reason why somebody can't read my story. Like, I want anybody to be able to read it.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why publishing the normal way isn't appealing to me. I was thinking, like, if I do publish, I would publish, like, through Amazon. And then make it, like, really cheap. And then, like, have times where you can get it for free.
Mm.
Because I don't want people to be like, I don't have the money. Because I know that feeling.
Mm.
I know the feeling to where, like, you want to get a book.
Yeah.
Or a comic book or something. And you're like, I can't because I don't have money. I know that feeling as a kid, right? And it's a shitty feeling. Because you see other people who are able to do it. And then you're like, I wish I...
That Scholastic Book Fair, boy.
That Scholastic Book Fair.
That hit different.
Yeah, it was always...
That hit different when you're poor.
It does. It really does.
You see these kids with fucking badass shit.
They get all their fucking books and all this really cool stuff.
You get fucking an eraser.
And then, yeah, eraser and a fucking pencil. And I want a fucking book. And I don't want, you know, young adults, you know, because that's who would be able to buy it, right?
Yeah.
You know, teens. I don't want them to feel that way. And that's that's really why whenever I meet writers who are so fucking elitist about their work,
mm-hmm.
I'm like, you fucking piece of shit.
They think themselves at the same level of Shakespeare and fucking, you know, Rowling and those fucking people.
And they Fouled. Do it in a way where it's like if they've forgotten where they've come from,
mm-hmm.
you know? There's a part of me that is like, I haven't forgotten where I've come from.
Yeah.
But you meet some people and you're just like, you're fucking... Like, you think, only people at my level should be able to read this.
Mm.
I'm like, what's your objective? Is your objective to surround yourself with other assholes?
Yeah.
Is that what it is? Yeah, that's what I'm going for.
Mm.
I'm going for, in terms of story, just this overarching story of a young man who... I said I wasn't going to go into the plot.
Yeah.
Basically, this young man, he's going through life, and he's... I brought it up a little bit, and I was like, he's trying to be someone who he thinks he is.
Mm-hmm.
And ignoring who he really is. Something like that.
To that effect.
Yeah. And I decided on that because I had an epiphany. And I was on a dating app.
Okay.
And I was looking at all this stuff, all these profiles, and I'm like, okay, all this stuff is cool.
I don't know what that was. Don't ask me.
Like, all this stuff is cool. Like, seems like we have a lot of things in common or whatever. And, like, the idea of trying to build a dating profile is, like, who... You're trying to do a dating profile, you gotta, like, sell yourself, basically.
Yeah, you do.
So it's like, who...
Not that I know. I've never had a dating profile.
Yeah.
Unless you count my MySpace.
My MySpace.
Yeah, okay, so...
So on the dating profile, it's like, are you putting who you think you are?
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like that's what I see a lot of. Like, if I were to, and I've done it before, where I was like, oh, I like comics, I like this, and I do, but I don't read them.
Yeah.
Like, I don't reach out, I don't go to the comic book store and look for comic books mm-hmm. to buy and read. But I do like comic books. Like, you put one in front of me, I'm going to read it. They're really enjoyable. I love yeah. the artwork.
Yeah.
So there's like, it's like, I had built a, there's a one time where I had built a profile and it was what I thought I was able to present
myself. How about this? We'll do this.
Mm-hmm.
You, and then this is, I've never built a profile, but let's build each other profiles.
Mm.
Give me an example of what you think you, like, since we know each other so much.
Right.
What would my profile, like, say?
Oh, man.
Okay, and then since you gave me a tab, like, a point of reference, I'll do it to you.
Okay. So I'll tell you what I'll focus on. Okay. First, I'll have a few pictures up of you, okay. right? I have some pictures of, I've had like maybe three pictures.
Mm-hmm.
It'll be three pictures of you, and then it'll be like some pictures of maybe a cocktail or two.
Okay.
And then maybe like something that you hobby with. Or an animal.
Okay.
Right? And the pictures would be different. Some of them would be nice. Some of them would be like maybe you out in like nature.
Mm-hmm.
If you have any nature pictures. I don't take a lot of pictures.
Yeah, same.
I don't take a lot of pictures, but I feel like that would be like one to kind of just throw in there. Right?
Okay.
I'll just throw in there for like brevity's sake.
Yeah. Whatever.
And then I feel like you would talk about... So like, I feel... Because it kind of has to be brief, these profiles.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
So briefly, you would touch on... you wouldn't touch on your job. Like, that's... Because that isn't, like, your personality. Your job isn't your personality. Mm-hmm. So you wouldn't touch on that. I think you would touch on, like, your enjoyment of hobbies. of different kinds of hobbies.
Mm-hmm.
You will list the different kinds of hobbies. I think you maybe, I would say you would touch on both D&D and Warhammer, as in things you enjoy doing. And if you could, you could explain a little bit about like the positives of it, like the community.
So, okay, so let's put this in wording, right?
Okay.
Okay, so Tommy.
All right, so it'd be like profile. Tommy profile.
And it's age gonna be like blank.
Age right? blank. So it'd be like
Big boy.
Big boy. It's like, hey, just looking for love. No. Mm-hmm. it'd be like it's actually my first time doing this, mm-hmm. but here's just a brief thing about me. I enjoy a lot of different hobbies, in no particular order. You have Dungeons and Dragons, I have Warhammer, and one that I found not too long ago was making cocktails. Because I'm not a bartender, but I enjoy the different kinds of drinks, and hey, maybe I can make some for you.
Mm.
And that would be kind of like your profile.
Yeah.
Like, it'd be very brief. And then on profiles, they have like all this stuff like if you have any kids, no, smoking, zero, no, drinking. Zero. Socially.
Yeah, socially.
Religious, I'm say like agnostic,
mm-hmm.
just to keep, you know, doors open.
Yeah.
And it's just a bunch of other stuff.
Okay.
So I feel like it would be brief, that you would lean on the cocktail side a little bit. Because it gives you a chance to talk about a hobby that you really enjoy. And also alcohol. It's a good icebreaker.
All right, I got yours. All right. Hey, gals.
Gals?
Gals.
What am I, a fucking 1940s businessman?
Sometimes it can be. What, you want bitches? What do you want? What do you want?
Let's go with gals.
Gals? You don't want girls, or do you
hey,
want...
Hey, girlies.
Hey, women.
Hey, women.
My name is Woman Respector 94. No, right? You don't want that. Hey, gals. I was, you know, sort of like, does it make you very, I don't know if it makes you misogynist, but hey, gals.
No.
Right? Okay, there you go. Hey, gals. My name's Eddie. Just looking for comfort. That's too much. Comfort seems like you're looking for a lady of the night, right?
Yeah,
no. You're not necessarily looking for companionship. I think companionship is something that's underrated.
It is.
Like, you want that person next to you, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not even, it's not love, but it's not carnal. It's not carnal. It's not, you know, lust. It's that being, right? That you don't get irritated when they're near you.
Right.
Looking for companionship. Mm. I enjoy many things. My hobbies are very creative. Dungeons and Dragons, writing, and just, I feel like you're more homebody.
Mm-hmm.
So I would probably notate that, well, homebody. Mm-hmm. First love, Kaylith. And I would be like, family oriented,
mm-hmm.
family oriented, you know, and yeah, I think that's pretty much, and gaming.
Mm-hmm.
Gaming's a really big part of our lives, right?
It really is. It really is.
But I don't want to... Gaming, but no gamer girls.
Gaming, but no...
So, hey, let's hop on Minecraft.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. We're some politicians.
Yeah.
So gaming movies. So, yeah, basically...
Gaming movies...
I'd say what you described is pretty much what it is.
Yeah.
That's kind of like... Mine is a family-oriented part. I don't have that on there.
No?
I don't know why.
But you are.
But I am. I feel really like am. You are. I really am. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I focus on the things I like, the things about me. But before, it was always a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
And
I feel like keeping it simple is always.
Yeah. Just short keep and sweet. It simple. Yeah, because I come across some fucking profiles.
Mm-hmm.
They're just Pisces. Really long. Pisces. So many people who love, like, just their fucking zodiac signs. Mm-hmm. I see a lot of, first and foremost, Jesus Christ comes first in my life. And I'm like, left, which is no.
Yeah.
Right, which is yes.
Okay.
I see a lot of, for a while, I was seeing a lot of, like, I'm just a passenger princess. You know what that is, right?
Yeah, I know what that is.
Yeah. For those of you who don't know what that is, it's just a girl who doesn't drive.
Yeah.
And you gotta drive everywhere.
That's what I enjoyed about that the person I'm with, right? It's not really that. They're not passenger. If anything, I would be considered the passenger.
You'd be considered.
Because like whenever I went on vacations,
mm-hmm.
she did a lot of the leg work on those fucking drives. And I mean.
I'm pulling up a dating app right now. I won't call. Let's see what it is. So let's say we have this.
No, it's Grindr. I like that one too.
Not Grindr.
What's the other one? Bumble? Is Bumble straight?
Bumble's it's like straight. I mean, it's whatever, you know. It's
Hinge? Bumble. Hinge is another one?
Hinge is another one. Here's another one.
I hear Hinge is good.
I hear Hinge is good too. I've tried it.
Yeah.
And I've never had a look on any fucking dating. On none of them.
Yeah, I can. I can only wonder.
Yeah. Fuck. I mean, it's hard to look at the upside sometimes when my romantic life is very like. But
look, man. I mean,
it's just I need to like. It's hard to meet. It's hard for me to make.
Do you feel though that you're putting enough effort into your romantic life?
No.
Do you want to? Not at all.
Do I want to?
You feel like you're in that position. That you can put effort.
I feel. So my problem was like, for a long time I thought I was in the position where I could put effort into a romantic relationship. And I really wasn't.
Yeah.
And I didn't know that I wasn't. Mm-hmm. So it bothered me for many years. The problem is I have my character, I don't know if I'm describing it with the right word, but I feel like the provider.
Mm-hmm.
Like that feels like something that I naturally fall into, right? Not so much as a, you know, looking for a, like a sugar daddy, right?
Because exactly,
it's like, hey,
but you still want something for your trouble, right? Like,
yeah,
like I don't want to just be this person that's.
I don't want to be here to just pay for your things, right?
Yeah.
Like this is a relationship. It's a two-way street, but at the same time, I'm gonna take care of you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like I get it. Like, and I know there are some women who are like, I don't need no man to take care of me. Great, cool for you. But if I were in a relationship, it'd be like things like, for example, like
I don't mind if my girl takes care of me either.
Yeah,
she had the money, and she was like, she had let's go to Sawgrass.
Like, all right, let's fucking go.
I can't. I didn't get paid that well this week, right?
Yeah.
Like, oh no, I didn't ask that. I said, let's go to Sawgrass. I'm like, yes, mommy.
Yes, mommy. Yeah. And that's great. I think for me, it's also like, for example, like house stuff.
Mm-hmm.
They say like, if let's say I own a house, I have a house, right? And then I had a girlfriend who made her wife or whatever, who made equal amounts of money or mm-hmm. a little bit less, but she was still making money. And she'd be like, hey, let's do like, let's split the house 60-40 or 70-30.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, that's fine. Like that is, that I feel like that's important in a relationship. The idea of like, oh, I'm the man and I'm going to pay for everything. No fucking way, dude. It's way too
much.
Not in
this anymore.
Not in this fucking, not in today's economy.
Maybe 40 years ago.
Maybe 40 years ago when your fucking money was like gold.
Yeah.
And I've seen some women who, I see women, but like on dating apps, they'd be like, bro. I don't pay for anything. Like, you better treat me good. I'm like, fuck you.
I don't know if, I always watch those things where they're saying like, how much does your man have to make? And they'd be saying these outrageous numbers,
yeah, bro. They'd be like, oh, 100K. Yeah, I'm like, that is.
750, I'm like, what are you looking at? Like,
who fucking.
Why do you feel like you deserve that much?
Yeah.
Fucking.
Yeah. Why do you think that you at your part-time barista job, I'm being very fucking generous here. Yeah. Who do you think at your part-time.
Or
who
a fucking bottle girl.
Yeah. Fucking doing. You think that your job as a bottle service girl is going to get you a guy who makes 150K a year? That man is married.
Yeah.
Right? Like, you're not going to find someone like.
What's the median for like, isn't it like median's like 60?
I think so, yeah.
Something like that, right?
Like, decent enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're way outside that median, lady.
Mm-hmm.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But I think for a very long time, I thought I was in a position where I could be in a relationship, mm-hmm. and I really wasn't. You know, I had a lot of issues. And it's not until, like, recently that I was like, I see I was wasting my time thinking I was ready and I wasn't.
Mm.
Now I think I am.
Now you think you are?
Now I think I am. I really do. I mean, let's look around. I have a job where
you're stable.
I'm stable. I have a job where I'm growing. I have a house. I'm much more emotionally mature.
Mm.
Right. There's been a lot of like positive changes, basically. And I think that was only possible because I've made mistakes.
Yeah.
So I've made mistakes. I learned from my mistakes. Make positive changes. Then, but I haven't. So now it's like, okay, I'm somewhere where I think I'm okay, right?
Mm-hmm.
I was like, well, okay, so what? Like, what kind of effort can I put? When I was thinking about going to that place, I told you about how, like, the dueling pianos.
Yeah,
I won't say the name of it.
Yeah, I don't remember the name either.
Yeah, but I was thinking about, I was like, oh, maybe I can go to that place, maybe. Because the thing is, it's like, I've also, one big thing is I've become more sociable.
That's good.
I can talk to people a lot more naturally, if that makes sense. Like, I do good in
social. For me, I don't want to say that, right? I can talk to people more naturally. I don't want to say that. Or I don't say that, at least. I say I can talk to people with this facade. Mm. For me, at least, it's like, until I actually know you, you're getting a facade from me, right?
Yeah.
Like, this nice, sociable person that, you know, whatever, right? Hey, how you doing? Oh, what do you do? What? Small chat. That's all it is. It's facade, too, until you get those reachers out. I guess that's the pessimist in me, right? Whatever, fuck it. But I know what you mean.
So yeah, it's. I would say that, I would do good in social situations before.
Yeah.
Like I could go if I were to go to like a gathering, I could talk to people and all that stuff, right?
Have you ever been good at like courting? You can talk to people, be social, right?
Yeah.
But that's different compared to like,
yeah.
There's people that have game, right? They can be ugly motherfuckers, whatever, but they got game. Right. That's their courting, right? That's their courting rituals. Girls fall for it, right?
Yeah.
So I don't like, how do you feel like your courting is?
Not good.
Not good either.
Not good.
I don't think so.
I haven't tried it
in a while.
So the whole thing with being, it's the.
I feel like I'm nice, and I have like things that I can like.
What works for me is that I'm nice.
Mm-hmm.
That works for me. I like to treat people with respect, and I have this tendency to make people laugh.
Yeah,
you know, I'm able to be silly.
Oh my god, you're so funny.
Yeah, stuff like that. But it's
bastard. Just. You know, Judy's best girl for me, and you bastard. And then, all right, we'll get back to that later.
And so it's like, I guess like the idea of courting for me is like, what's my objective?
Mm-hmm.
Is my objective is to meet someone so that we can start dating and see where it goes, right? The guys who have game have that because they do it all the time.
Mm.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does.
Because I mean, that's how you build a skill. You do it a lot. Mm-hmm. So these guys who have game, sure, they're going around and like talking these ladies up, but also their objective isn't to start a relationship, to maybe start dating and all this stuff. Maybe a lot of them are probably just trying to like smash.
Yeah.
Right? So having game like that makes sense. And it's not, and as I we talked about in the podcast before, I can't, like, I need an emotional connection with,
That's the difference.
Yeah.
Emotional connection.
I need an emotional connection with someone.
Mm-hmm.
I can't, like, which requires time, it requires time, investing time into relationship, right? And I think that's where I hesitate. I'm like, okay, I know the connection that I need to have there, and it's like I gotta invest the time. I gotta find somebody to invest that time with. So it's more than just courting. It's like finding someone to
compatible.
I think I'm just tired, boss.
I'm tired, boss. Well, that's too damn bad.
You know. I mean, I'll see how it goes, right? It's right now, I know for sure I'm in a comfortable spot to, like, start trying to date.
That's good.
Trying to meet people.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of, like, where do I go? And that's the thing. It's like, so this goes back to, like, who I think I am versus who I am.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, do I go to places where I think I should be there? Or to places where I know I should be there? Hmm. Like, bars.
Yeah.
Clubs. I know I shouldn't be there.
We know we shouldn't be there.
Yeah, but the most, that's how people meet other people.
Yeah.
So do
that's I... That's that social gathering.
Yeah. And there's also other things like, like events, like an art show.
Mm-hmm.
Should I, like, do I think that I should be there because I think that's who I am, someone who goes to these art shows?
What do you think about, like, places that do, it's not speed dating, but it's more like, it's a gathering for singles. Like, because they're there for a reason, right? They're also there for a reason. They want to find that person, too.
Now, here's the question. Okay, now here's the pessimist in me.
Right.
It's like, what if they're there just to find somebody to fucking have sex with?
You don't know. Same as a bar, though.
Yeah.
Same as a bar. You don't know if they're there to, like, find Mr. Right or Mrs. Right.
Yeah.
You know?
So for me, it's always like, where do I go? And people have recommended I'll go to those single things. And I was like, there's also this kind of like,
I feel like so it's less likely for a girl to go just to get fucked.
Yeah.
I feel like they're there because they're like alone.
But here's also like, I think it's, tell me if this makes sense. Okay. Like, I feel like going to those places, automatically, people are going to be putting up a facade. Because they need to
impress.
They need to impress, yeah. So they need to put up a facade in these places.
I don't feel like you have to, though. Well, okay.
No, I'm, you don't have to.
Yeah, you
but
don't
I feel
to.
Like people.
Oh, for sure.
People are worried that, like, oh, who I am is gonna scare people off.
Yeah.
So I need to like be someone I'm not. Yeah. And so I think there's a little bit of that on there, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I just have to find those places where the fuck they are.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wherever the fuck they are. So I think there's a little bit of that as well, right? Like, it's this weird thing. It's like going there with that objective. Like, are you going to be yourself? Or are you going to be someone else to attract others?
Mm-hmm.
But the ones that you attract won't be the ones that are attracted to yourself, but attracted to the facade.
I mean, that's if you put up a facade.
That's if you put up a facade.
Yeah. I feel like if you're there, you're there to be you and your original you, right?
That would be the ideal situation.
That would be.
But once again, people can feel very uncomfortable.
Well, I feel like this is what happens, right? Yeah. You go, you show your real you, and nothing happens.
And then you're like, oh shit, nobody wants the real me.
Yeah, exactly. So then you have to put up that facade. Like, oh yeah, I do this. Oh, I love that. Oh, you know, this, and this.
Yeah.
Oh, check this out. Da, 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 da.
And then that's when you're being someone you think you should be.
Yeah, exactly. Compared to who you are.
Who you are. So I will say that there was a time where I would put up a facade at places.
Mm.
Right. Now, I don't.
Good.
Now, it doesn't matter where I am. I try to be as much as myself as possible. You know, in a professional environment, I try to be myself still. So I just have to, like... And it's also, like, there's this thing where it's happened often enough to where, like, it demotivates me, mm-hmm. right? Where I'm, like, talking to a girl, I'm having a conversation or whatever, and then she's like, oh, yeah, my boyfriend this. And I was like...
Fuck you.
And, like, I
No, I felt it tonight, believe me.
Yeah.
I felt it tonight. I feel your... I don't know if I felt my pain or your pain.
I think you felt both our pains.
Yes.
Because yeah. I felt my pain.
Yeah. I felt my pain.
Yeah.
I felt...
And so the thing is like, you can see that I've been very friendly with you, right? So you're being this... Like, you're matching my energy of friendliness.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're like, oh, no, wait, I have a boyfriend. Like, sometimes I feel like it's they do have a boyfriend. Sometimes I feel like it's they don't.
Mm-hmm.
And they just wanted some attention.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of times it's also been where maybe I'm bringing too much into the situation. Because I'm starved for attention.
Or, so, no, you're starved for...
Companionship.
For that intimacy.
And I meet someone who...
God,
who really being starved gets for me.
Intimacy is... It breaks people down.
Yeah. And that's how I made a lot of mistakes. So, in part, I do take some blame. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have to take some blame, right? Yeah. Because I know the mistakes I made, right? I mean, there was this... I don't think I've talked about it on the podcast, but it was shortly after I left out of the army.
Mm-hmm.
I gained a lot of weight.
Okay.
And this one girl gave me attention. I was very depressed. Mm-hmm. I got out for specific reasons. Nothing bad.
Yep.
But I felt like a failure.
Murder
in Minecraft.
Yeah. So you got out, yeah.
But yeah, and I felt like a failure.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I just... And then also, I was talking to a girl, and then a girl that I had liked in high school, and then... You know, we hung out a few times, and then she ghosted me completely. After she was like, oh, you actually have a restraining order on this guy. I was like, oh, wow. And then she goes silent.
Yeah.
So my thought process just fucking went like, they fucking killed her.
Yeah.
And I knew where she lived because I had, you know, gone over there.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, hey, you know, is she okay? It's like, all this stuff. I was worried.
Yeah.
She's like, oh, no, yeah, she went to the club with her sister. Mm. And I was like, oh, okay. I was just... And I was like, I didn't know what to say.
Yeah.
One, I felt like shit because I drove over there, right?
Yeah.
And you, like, this person tells you, because this person is talking to you and they are crying because this whole relationship went to shit, right? and they tell you I had to get a restraining order because, you know, they put their hands on me, all this stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then they go quiet. Like, that would make anybody worry.
Yeah.
I never heard from them ever again,
right?
And, but I was in a very tough spot after that. And then later on, this girl shows up and she starts giving me a lot of attention. Like, a lot of attention. And I'm like, oh my God, this is amazing.
Yeah.
So I put on my horse blinders, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I just went into the deep end.
Yeah.
And I made some mistakes. And my mom would loved reminding me about those mistakes for like a good 2-3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And every time she would bring it up, I'm like, why you gotta bring it up? Like, I already felt like shit. But the whole situation ended, basically was like, ended up going broke, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, oh, I want to take a break, but you can't see anybody. We can't see anybody. All this stuff. And I was like, okay, yeah, sure, whatever. Yeah. So we took a break. And during that break, it was like 2 weeks. She got engaged.
Fuck.
Yeah. There's some of her stuff in my apartment. And I'm like, she told me, oh, I got engaged. We can't be together anymore. I was like, what the fuck? You told me we were on a break. We can't see anybody. And you got engaged?
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, you're yelling at me? Don't yell at me. I'm like, I'm not yelling at you.
First of all, where do you find the time to meet, to get engaged in 2 weeks?
She'd been talking to him already.
Oh.
Yeah.
So I was just,
I was just someone there to give her attention. So there's some of her stuff still in my apartment. So I told her, hey, come.
Okay, I'm sorry. Were y'all sleeping together?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
And so I told her, hey, come get your stuff in my apartment.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, my car isn't working right now. And I was like, find a way.
Yeah.
So she got a friend to bring her over. And I'm sitting on my couch, I'm watching TV. It's in the first apartment, the one that,
flooded?
Mm-hmm. And I'm watching TV, and, she stands in front of the TV. I'm watching a movie. She stands in front of the TV. She, like, puts up her hand where the ring is. She's like, it's too big. It doesn't really fit my finger. She's, like, fidgeting with it, pointing, getting at me.
Mm.
And I was like, okay, get your shit. And she goes, and she's like, where's my stuff? I'm like, it's in that black trash bag right there.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, you touch my stuff? I'm like, it's in my apartment. Like, I told you I was going to put it in a bag. She's like, you shouldn't have touched my stuff. It's my stuff. I was like, get your shit and get out.
Yeah.
And she grabbed whatever was remaining and she left. She said, all right, well, bye. And I'm like,
leave. Adios.
And she tried talking with me a few times. And I never responded.
Yeah.
But I made mistakes because I was a broken man then, very young, 20 years old.
Yeah.
And the mistake was a combination of I had gained a lot of weight, I was depressed, I felt like a failure. Someone took advantage of that, and I allowed it. And then I was like, never going to happen again.
Mm.
And it didn't. But something similar happened. But not to the same degree.
Mm.
It was different circumstances. And it was basically someone saying, oh, I'm getting a divorce, actually. I'm getting a divorce. And I'm like, okay, yeah. So we started talking. This is this. I'm like, I'm not going to do anything until you get a divorce. And then I thought it was going well. She's like, I decided to not get a divorce.
Lovely.
Yeah. So I was like, all right, well, I'm gonna pull back then. And she's like, you're acting different. And I was like, I'm like, you know how I feel about you.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, no, you don't feel like that about me. I was like, what the fuck? Like, how are you going to tell me that I don't feel a certain way? And it was another situation. I was again depressed, gained some weight. Someone was giving me attention. And I just fell for a different kind of trap.
Mm.
So, shame on me twice.
Yeah. You get one more chance.
One more chance. But after that, I made some changes in my life. I've been constantly making some changes.
Yeah.
So I have my... I have my... my hesitance for certain reasons. Bad experiences.
Love is tricky.
Love is tricky. But I love love. I can tell you, I can say this. When it comes to love, I love like no one else. I'm a very passionate person.
Mm.
I think just finding the right person, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know when that'll happen. But I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing. Such as playing D&D.
Sometimes they just come into your life. Well, naturally. Sometimes you got to look. It's up to you. I think for my situation, I think I had to look. Mm-hmm. And then I look. Yeah. It was interesting. I look back on it a lot. But that's for another time. What else?
Well, we had to play some D&D today.
We did play some D&D.
That's why it was such a long day. So right now, we still got some time to record. Because like I said, we're going to do a long episode.
What are we doing?
You know, it's 12:30. It's 12:23 a.m. It's past midnight right now. Sunday.
We
recorded into a new day.
We're going to eat breakfast. Yeah, we're just gonna have a full English. 12:30.
So fucking beans and
yeah. Fucking beans.
Fucking beans.
Why?
Oh man.
Look. Wait. Okay, wait. I get the appeal because we're Hispanics. We grew up with fucking beans and cheese.
Yeah, I love beans.
But they do baked beans.
That's a big difference.
It's a big difference.
It's a very big difference. I'm not an animal.
Yeah.
Sorry,
God, that's so weird.
Sorry, my British brethren, but on some things we gotta disagree.
Yeah. Sorry.
Also, fuck the queen.
Okay. I mean,
I won't eat. You see that Norm MacDonald video? You know who Norm MacDonald is?
Refresh my memory.
He was in a lot of like movies with like with Adam Sandler.
Did he die?
He died, yeah. Like 2 years ago, whatever.
I think so. I think so.
He was on the podcast and he had like a bucket of fried chicken in front of him. And he was like, I will not eat a single morsel of food until Margaret Thatcher is dead and buried. And they're like, she died like 30 years ago. He's like, come on. He just starts eating the fucking chicken like an animal.
God damn it.
So I'm going to start doing that with the queen.
The Iron Lady. I think that was her was the nickname, Iron Lady.
The Iron Lady, yeah.
Yeah.
I heard she was a horrible person.
Margaret Thatcher?
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Horrible things. Yeah, I mean, after we did crawfish, we're going to go to this comic book store, Bedrock City.
Dilapidated, no longer in existence.
Gone. Reduced to ashes.
Yeah. No, they moved.
Reduced to atoms. Yeah, they moved.
They did move to a bigger location, by the way.
It's bigger. Well, I mean, where they were, I remember going there, and it was getting, like, full.
Yeah.
Like, they had, like, a lot of things in that small
shop. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with that shop, right? It was ghetto. But the new place, the area was not...
The area was not somewhere where it could make money.
Yeah, exactly. It couldn't thrive under the heel of the... Okay, never mind.
It basically, it was near a road that was used mainly to, like, travel through.
Yeah, and traffic.
There's nothing around there. Like, yeah. There was a fucking a Red Lobster nearby that was boarded up.
Yeah.
There was a TJ Maxx that was closed. Mm. It's just shit was just, you know, closing.
Yeah, it was garbage.
So they had to move.
It was next to the Crackhead Dollar Theater fucking.
Yeah, I remember that place. They closed down there.
Yeah, that's close too.
Yeah, that close too. Yeah.
Fuck.
But
the Bennigan's gone. No, I'm kidding. There's never a Bennigan's place.
And so we went over, we finished up the crawfish, went down the road, really close by.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw that it was I didn't see like the sign from far away. You can kind of see it. I approached.
There was no sign.
There was no sign.
That was the grime of the no longer existing sign.
And so
that spelled out a semblance of that comic book store.
So I still got out of the car to go see because I wanted to see if there was any information. And there was. And I found out they moved about 20 something minutes away.
Mm-hmm.
Which wasn't enough time for us to go over there and then go to D&D. So we finished up and then I was going to go to the store to get something to drink. And then Tommy's like, I'm going to the Baskin Robbins.
Hell yeah.
And I'm like, are you going to the Baskin Robbins? He's like, yeah. And I'm like, all right, I'll meet you there. It was close by. It was like in the same parking lot.
Yeah, I had to settle down my stomach from all that fucking spicy crawfish.
Yeah. You know what was weird? I've been to Baskin Robbins before, and they're like, all right, what do you want on it? And you can put a bunch of stuff. This one, they're like, okay, here you go.
Yeah.
There was like, hey, man, I want some fucking sprinkles.
They had them on the side.
They had them on the side, yeah.
But they didn't offer.
No, he just put it on there, and he's like, all right, it's going to be this. And I was like, can I get some toppings? He's like, some toppings? I was like, yeah. He's like, what do you want? I'm like, some sprinkles on like a chocolate or color on chocolate. This fucking moron. Fucking stupid-ass 16-year-old kids.
Damn it. Ruining this generation.
Probably just some fucking kids trying to do their job, right? I don't know why they're not doing the toppings. Probably they don't have the space or whatever.
Just do your job.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. At least do the bare. At least do the minimum, right?
Yeah. I mean, come on, man. Like, you're not going to offer me toppings. It's part of the job.
It's part of the role.
In America, we do our job.
Yeah. You're a cone connoisseur, sir.
Cone connoisseur.
No, they actually had a title.
Oh, they did?
You didn't see the now hiring sign that said something needed. And it was like a big fucking...
Oh, some fucking...
Cream master or some fucking weird title, right? Cream meister?
Yeah.
I don't fucking know. Yeah. It was a weird title, bro. Cone connoisseur, something like that.
Yeah, some fake ass shit.
Yeah, fake ass Baskin Robbins.
Fake ass Baskin
Robbins. 31 flavors, my dick.
So after that, we went to our friend's house, swanging on the road.
Swanging.
I started swanging. I couldn't.
It had to be. It was Houston.
Yeah, just fucking swanging. For you, those of you who don't know, swanging. Look it up, bitch.
Oh my god. No, you don't have to look it up. I'll tell you what it is. It's swanging. That's all you get. That's all you get. Look at. Find the song. What is it? Swang?
Look it up, bitch.
Look it up, bitch.
We gave you a recipe to margarita day. Yeah. We gave you recipes and all sorts of shit. Do something for yourself.
Look it up. Swang. How do you spell it? So they can look it up.
S-Wang. Swang.
S-Wang. You son of a bitch.
And then we went to our friend's house. I forgot
by the way, we're not. We don't have cool cars to do this in.
No, we don't. My dice are right here. They're there. I forgot them. I thought they were in my trunk because I had a bunch of D&D
stuff. Whose dice were you using?
I was using it on my phone.
Oh,
yeah.
You should have told me. I would have given you some dice.
Nah, I just used them.
But then you don't get the click clacking. Your fucking dice.
I didn't really have the space for it.
Oh,
that's why I was like, I'll set up for this.
fucking crying.
And then we got to finish up the one shot.
Yeah. Woo!
Plenty of mystery I see going on. I see a lot of people confused or asking questions.
I don't have to be confused.
I'm not smart enough to be confused. I don't understand enough to be confused.
Exactly.
But I've had some ideas for it of where I wanted to go. And once everybody decided that, we would want to do this again, to continue the story of this one shot. I'm like, perfect. I got an idea of where it's going, how I'm going to do it.
Just making sure. We're doing Strahd next session?
I'm assuming we are.
Okay, just...
I think we're going to like...
That's what I heard too.
Yeah. I don't know how they... I don't know how they want
to do it. It's not this Saturday, but...
Okay. Yeah. I don't know how they want to do it though.
Well, I'm going to give a recap and...
Well, I don't know if they want to do it like, oh, above 2 weeks.
Oh, scheduling-wise.
Yeah.
Oh, we'll find out.
Because if we do Strahd, then we're probably going to stick to that for a while.
Yeah.
If we just don't set anything up.
Yeah. We'll figure it out.
Yeah. And then... I enjoyed it again. Had some fun. I was trying to keep it really short. I was doing my best, actually, to keep it short.
But I wanted to go to the whorehouse.
Yeah, I know. So did I.
But you know, I was rejected, damn it. I was rejected.
So this is Bunny Girl. Named Judy.
No reference.
No, no relation.
Don't get the,
No relation. And I did the old, I can show you around town. I get off at 8.
The old bottle girl service.
All right. I just have to check with my boyfriend.
The sting.
Did I tell you about that? I don't know if I should. I don't know. Maybe not on the podcast. Because I know about someone who paid like, who spent $3,000 one time on bottle service.
And one of our friends?
No, it wasn't. But
then what does it matter? Not someone. You know. Do I know them?
No.
Okay, fuck it. Yeah, say that.
No. No.
Do it. Do it, you coward.
All right. I'll use aliases. Someone I know.
Okay.
A friend of mine is telling me about their boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They told me that their boyfriend likes his one specific bar. I was like, I wonder why.
Mm-hmm.
And we were going...
You have given me... I feel like you've given me the story, maybe.
I think I have.
God,
but we were going as a group. I don't remember
it that much. Oh, okay.
It was a group of friends
mm-hmm.
going to this bar. And we got there, and there was just ladies in, like, lingerie. Orange. It was all the same color. Or, like, orange lingerie.
Yeah.
Very sexy ladies. Very sexy.
Did you find them attractive?
Physically attractive, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And they tried to, we got like some bottle service and they're like just trying to upcharge you, right?
Yeah.
They ended up paying for a $600 bottle of vodka, which
Grey Goose.
Last I checked, almost all vodka tastes the same.
Yeah. Was it Grey Goose?
I don't know. I didn't have any.
Oh.
I was done drinking for the night.
Probably Beluga.
Yeah. But they're like, basically, there's a few people who spent basically the entire time where they're trying to fucking fight the bill. Not really enjoying their time. Just because it's fucking...
Ridiculous.
Ridiculous ass charge. And they did not order that one. They ordered something completely different.
Yeah.
And some guy ended up paying, but it's this guy who thinks he has a lot of swagger.
So they ended up paying for that.
Mm-hmm. They split it between like the people who were there.
Yeah.
Who were drinking it. I didn't drink any.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the only people who didn't pay were some females who like basically ignored it.
Yeah.
That it ignored that they were drinking it, right? And the next day the friend of mine who was there with her boyfriend, she was like, "Oh, that's actually his favorite spot." And I was like, oh, shit. I'm like, why? It fucking sucks.
Yeah.
And I know why. You know, the sexy ladies, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, he actually spent $3,000 on his birthday when he went there. I'm like, for bottle service? She was like, yeah. I was like, that's fucking insane. $3,000 on your birthday for bottle service. Listen,
I'm sure if you go to a strip club and spend $3,000... you'll get some fucking pussy.
Oh, yeah. You're not going to get that at this club.
Yeah.
No. That $3,000, I could do so much with that.
Mm-hmm.
So much. I could buy a new TV, put it up here.
$3,000, I feel, is like a pretty good, like, decently priced whore. If you just want fucking, like, what are you doing? Like, are you? Do you just want the attention for $3,000, or do you want?
It's a. I'll tell you what it is.
Pussy for $3,000.
I'll tell you what it is. It's a fucking idiot.
Yeah,
that's what it is. It's an idiot with money, and I'm just speculating. I met him a few times. I don't like him.
I can see why.
Is that and before I found that out, right? There's also like the way he like. In front of my friend, the way he like interacted with other women, like the way he hugged them, like very like if you're in front of your girl, you're not gonna like embrace, you know, two women at the same time. You're not gonna be like, ah, and then like bring them in really close and tight.
Yeah,
like give a little side hug, bye. You're not gonna fucking embrace women like that, and just it was just like there was that, and there's okay. I'm gonna tell you what bothered me the most. The most. We went to an event. It was at this place called Topgolf.
I've never heard of it. What is
So Topgolf? Yeah. For those of you who don't know, look it up, bitch. Topgolf is basically you have like three tiers. You go and you just fucking hit balls. People take it. Some people take it very seriously to try to get some points. Nice. It's fun, right? You get balls. Some drinks. You get some food. They got a bar. Here's what bothered me the most about this guy.
Okay.
Is that we went to Topgolf. People wearing their fucking jeans. Just having beers. You know, throwing them back. Just, like, fucking hitting golf balls and, you know, just hanging out, chilling, right? This guy came in, like, a fucking golf shirt, golf shorts, golf shoes.
Golf shoes.
Like, fucking shoes you wear, comfortable shoes to fucking play golf or whatever.
Really? I didn't know there was golf shoes.
I'll have to look. I think some of them have cleats. No, I don't think they do. Basically, this man was dressed up, and he had a fucking golf glove. Like a glove for golf.
Maybe he was thinking, maybe I could get some practice in while I'm with this
fucking... This motherfucker didn't swing a single club. He just had that fucking glove tucked into his back pocket. It's just the idea that, like, this is not...
I'm guessing if this would have been, like, chilling, like, at a... You're chilling at a fucking, like, Texas bar... He would have had Western wear, like full Western wear.
And when we say full Western wear, I'm talking about like fucking chaps, spurs, a fucking lasso on his hip.
10-gallon hat.
Who the fuck is this guy? Yeah, like, right?
Are you fucking...
This is a roadhouse, Texas roadhouse, next to a highway.
I was going to say maybe like this fucking...
What's this is a fucking Chili's.
No, what's that?
Imagine going to a Chili's.
Uh-huh.
And you got a motherfucker dressed like that.
Yeah.
In fucking...
What's that place? It's called Saloon. It's in
Saloon?
Hair Saloon.
Oh, yeah. It's Hair... fuck. I can't remember. But I know which one you're talking about.
Yeah.
The logo is like the guy on a horse.
Yeah.
On a fucking Bronco.
Rodeo. Something like that.
Rodeo Saloon?
Yeah. Something like
I think
that.
So. Just in, like...
And him going like that.
Yeah. That's honestly what bothered me the most. Like...
Pretentious.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, everything else was just like, just, you know, cherries on top. I was like, oh yeah, this guy's the fucking, but it was that fucking outfit, bro.
Yeah.
I was like, we did not come here to play fucking golf. We came here to get fucked up.
God, I would have laughed it off. I would have laughed it off as soon as he came in the door. Are you serious?
Yeah. And that's when I first met him. And I was like,
hey yo, Tiger Woods.
hey yo, what's up, Tiger Woods?
Give me on Palmer.
Brings you to cups.
Fuck them.
Yeah. So that was That's that.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Yeah.
But you're pondering.
I am. I'm deep in thought.
What do you think about our format so far?
Of the podcast?
Well, okay, yeah, exactly. But like also, I mean, we both sort of listen to a couple podcasts, right? I assume.
Yeah.
What do you feel like we have certain things that set us apart from other podcasts?
Our audio quality.
It's garbage.
Yeah.
Sub-tier. You're probably hearing... Yeah.
I mean, I think we touch on a lot of different things.
Yeah.
I mean, I try to be very open. As much as I feel comfortable being.
I like trying to have the facts straight before I talk about it. Mm. Sometimes I don't get the opportunity. But... As always, that's why you have Google.
It's Google. Gotta get your Google. I just say what I think are facts that I heard.
Yeah.
Because I use
Bing instead.
I use Bing. Well, the thing is like I've some of the stuff I claim as facts. I've never claimed them to be facts.
Yeah, I've never said factual, right?
I've never said factual.
I'm just like, I heard about this. Yeah.
I thought, like, and that's all it is, right?
Yeah.
Because I'm not going to sit here and try to find that source that where I fucking
correct
read
me
it.
If I'm wrong.
Yeah, put it in the fucking comments, you bitch. I'm kidding. I'm sorry. I'm just a little tense.
It's best as nap time.
Daddy's tense. I think what sets us apart, I mean, it's us, man. It's us.
Yeah, but who are we? We're just some two schmucks in a fucking room, you know? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, compared to, like, Joe Rogan and fucking Dick Willis, right? These are people that are known and...
So these are big podcasts that have been around for years.
Exactly, right? Right?
But also, okay, so when you think about podcasts, a lot of the podcasts that I've heard or listened to, a lot of the people who make these podcasts have had some experience in the entertainment industry.
Mm-hmm.
And they decided to do a podcast where they were writers for something, or maybe they were did for some photography or show. Like they have.
Maybe that's why their podcasts are coherent.
Yeah,
and I feel like ours are just
here. Fucking everywhere.
Yeah,
but I
think that's our thing though.
That's us. We're two fucking schmucks just sitting.
Two bears.
We're two bears.
Two bears that fucking don't know anything.
Don't know a goddamn thing.
We're bears. What the fuck do bears know, right?
Yeah. And we just sit in my office,
game
room, whatever, cave.
Mm-hmm.
We're leaning very close on like... On that other podcast by Tom Segura and Bert Kreischer, because you just called this place the cave.
Oh yeah!
And before you remember the two bears.
Oh fuck! I forgot. I forget that their thing is thing.
They got it.
They got it. It's trademark. Fuck.
They got.
Sorry, we're two quadrupedal.
We're two bears
hibernating. We're marsupials. How about that? We'll take the marsupials.
It's you, me, and Dice.
Yeah, you, me, and Dice.
It's you, me, and Dice. really new.
His name is you. So why you? Me is M-I. Me. And Dice. You, me, Dice.
Yeah.
There is no Tommy. There's no Eddie.
There's only Legion.
Okay.
What sets us apart is like I said, we're just a bunch of average schmucks.
Yeah.
We're just some dudes who have.
By the way, I never thought I would do this. Podcast. No, I'm sorry. Vlogging, right? I always thought, like, in my head, right? Who the fuck are you that you're so important that you feel like you should, like, your opinion is this or your day is important to fill up my fucking feed?
Mm-hmm.
Right? I always thought that. It's weird, right? Like, who are you where I think you think I should listen to you, right?
I think you should. Well, but we're not here spreading like important information.
I guess so, right?
You know what I mean? Like we're not here. We're not like a news podcast, right?
No.
We're not here with news about daily anything. We're just here to shoot the shit.
I just never thought about it, right?
Right.
I never thought I would do this. I don't regret it, right? Because I get to talk and, you know, hang out.
But we offer a little bit of everything, man. Our format is hanging out. That's our format.
Yep.
Our format is hanging out, chilling like some villains.
I think that's good.
Like you, me, Dice, two bears, one mic, the two clubs. Dangerously close.
Don't worry. We're fine. We'll collab.
We'll collab.
We'll do four bears.
Sure. We'll collab with one of the biggest podcasts out there.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. We'll get it. Okay. Once we get our Raid Shadow Legends sponsor and our
and our Manscaped
and our HelloFresh
and our HelloFresh,
we'll get it. They'll be like, "Hey, y'all guys are really popular."
Yeah,
you know, no. Exactly, they reach out to us. We don't reach out to them.
Right. Okay. Well, here's the other thing that I haven't brought up, but their parent podcast, mm-hmm. the one that started it all, yeah. is called Your Mom's House, and their abbreviation is YMH.
Your Mom's House, and ours is YMD. All right. Before we get into legality here.
Listen, they seem like cool people, okay?
You never met Bert. He showers like a fucking... He showers in a pool. He will eat you alive in court. Let's not fuck with him, all right? We'll do some trademarking. We'll do some logo. We'll fix this up.
When I was coming up with, like, Dice with the podcast names, nothing felt right. Like, nothing felt good. And here's what I was starting doing is that whenever I title the podcast,
mm-hmm.
because we have You, Me, Dice,
yeah.
with Tom and Eddie,
yeah.
and then the title is always like three things that we talked about.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of like the first one, which is like, is Strahd a sub or dom?
I think we just called it
Strahd, sub or dom.
Yeah.
Now it's just like three adjectives that describe the podcast. So that's how I started doing it. I think that's what I'm gonna stick with.
That. Yeah, that's fine.
But yeah, we are.
My favorite title out of all of them was still Sad Bear Hours.
Sad Bear Hours, yeah.
Go look at it. Go read it. Go hear it.
Go hear it. I mean, we had some deep cutting stuff today.
Yeah, yeah.
Me talking about my.
You sad bastard.
My sad.
He's not. He's happy, guys.
Let's life with my relationship and how I'm.
Hey, what is that?
I'm worthless.
What is that? UFO?
And nobody wants me.
All right, guys, this is a good time to talk.
No. I mean, it's as sad as it sounds. I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah, that's good.
Honestly, a lot of it is just it's not so much. It's okay. It sounds really fucking sad. It really does, right? Looking at my history with relationships and looking at like my.
I don't open that book. I don't like the ending.
I'll tell you this. It sounds sad, but in reality, it's more like I'm problem solving.
That's good.
I'm trying to figure out how to approach it.
Yeah.
Because it's new to me.
Mm-hmm.
It's new to me as in like. It's new to this version of me.
Yeah.
Because this version of me has different perspectives.
People don't change, you fucking rat bastard. No, I get what you mean, though. Like, you know, like, we're constantly evolving. And as we grow older, some of us grow wiser, right? But...
Yeah.
It's just...
And that's, I think, before, in my unwise years... I wasn't looking at it from the right angle.
Like me, I've never noticed right about this in my relationship, right? But I am a creature comfort. Like my.
Like your love language is
intimacy.
Intimacy.
Yeah.
More touching.
Very yeah. much so.
Yeah, like hugging, holding hands.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very much so. It doesn't even have to be sexual.
Right.
It's a plus if it's sexual. It doesn't have to be.
Of course.
But, cool.
Oh, so, here's the thing.
Okay.
For me, if I don't have that emotional connection, the sex, it's difficult. Like, I don't enjoy it. I don't want to be there. Is it the same for you for, like, for like intimacy, for like that love language of touch and everything. If it's not there, if, like, is it difficult?
Yes.
It's difficult, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Because it's
because like that
that's what like, initiates it. That's what sparks it.
Yeah. You need that spark. You need that give and take.
Because I'm not gonna go too deep into the details. But I'd say when I was in a relationship, when I was very emotionally like connected with someone, like I went on for, I would say, a good hour and a half.
Yeah. What are you talking about? Are we talking about like intimacy? Oh, we're talking about
sex.
Intercourse.
Intercourse, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Coitus.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like I think 3 or 4 rounds.
Look at you, Black Dynamite.
I'm telling you, if the emotional connection is there, like, hey, no fucking problem.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to a relationship where there was no emotional connection once, and it was like maybe 10 minutes.
Yeah, you just want to be maybe. Done with it. You just want to be done with it.
I just want to be done with it. I want nothing to do with it. I don't care. Like, I'm not connected to you. But if I am, hey, time to put on that fucking chef hat and get to work.
Mm-hmm.
Time to start cooking. So on that note.
On that note.
But that's what it is for me.
That's cool. So, I think this is a good time.
Yeah. Yeah. I want to, I think this longer format, every 2 weeks, is gonna work. Like you said in the beginning, some changes in schedules and work schedules and responsibilities at work.
It's inevitable.
Yeah.
We even tinkered with the thought of like, okay, if we have a weekend or something, we can do like 2 sessions of this and then just pump him out, right? But
yeah,
I'm like, well, I mean, we can, but why not just do 1 long one?
Yeah,
give it a go. I mean, again, we don't know yet, right? We can work on multiple things, but we'll see how this keeps going. This was fun too. The longer sessions are fun too.
Yeah,
we got deeper into the topics that we wanted to.
Oh yeah. Once again, I'm just gonna go and I'm gonna go kill some politicians in Minecraft,
mm-hmm.
and then enjoy my last beer meal, and then get guillotined.
Nice. We won't tell you the server.
Yeah, the server's private.
Yeah.
FBI agent watching. We're just playing Minecraft. You silly goose.
Yeah. God, what? That's the view. That's the view. Like, that's our first viewer. Every podcast.
Every podcast at the very beginning is like
FBI agent
Alex Jones. Wait, isn't that the podcast guy?
Yeah, that's the podcast guy. I was going to say FBI agent, you know, like this.
Yeah, FBI agent liked it. It'd be like just, it's actually the username is like not FBI agent.
Yeah.
And then
Cool Guy Steve.
Cool Guy Steve. And it's just like a FBI agent with a mustache and glasses.
It's a name that like it's an acronym. It's the FBI, you know. But it's like Franklin, Burt.
Yeah. Franklin Burt Ingleton.
Yeah.
And he's like, yo, that Minecraft joke is so funny. What politician are you thinking about?
Yeah, what's your geographical coordinates?
No, they know. They know where we're at.
That's your IP address. So we can I really want to know.
So where you been in this tank? In Minecraft.
Oh, what is this improvised weapon you speak of?
Was it, have you seen that orange tank? That. Where he's like, I don't know if I can do it.
All right, give him a moment. Give him 1 moment. He's trying to get it. He's trying to take it out.
It's an orangutan just sawing a piece of wood.
I have seen that.
When your parents leave and you can finally get back to like your little project or whatever, and it's like, I'm building an IED. Or like when you're in court
and the judge tells you that, you know, you're in, makes fun of the improvised weapon, but it's all the finest materials you could find. Yeah. You're just a sad cat.
It has a song from the Red Dead Redemption 2 building montage.
Yeah. God damn it.
Oh, fuck.
So sad.
Well, I think it's Minecraft time.
Yeah.
Let's go do some Minecraft. If you guys enjoyed the podcast, I almost forgot to plug, not to plug, to promote, to motivate. Both. Both? If you guys like plug the podcast, both. Make sure to, if you're listening on YouTube, make sure to like, subscribe. You can tap that little bell icon to get a notification anytime a new episode goes up. Leave a comment. Let us know what you think. If you want to know what 18 Minecraft politicians they are, I'm not going to tell. Only if you're on the Minecraft server. And share it. If you think somebody else is going to enjoy this, share it.
Patreon.
This is entirely different from Two Bears, One Cave.
Yeah.
This is You, Me, and Dice with Eddie and Tommy.
Don and...
Two Grizzlies, One Castle.
Fuck it. No, you know what? Come at me, Bert.
Come at me, Bert. Come.
No, he's a monster, bro. He's a fucking monster.
He likes to drink.
Yeah. Yeah. No, but like, they talk about him, right? I think Rogan talked about him. He's like, no, that man's a fucking monster. Like, he's built, like, animalistic.
He's the machine.
Like, even though he's like, you know, like, heavy set.
Yeah.
Like, he can cut that and just, yeah. Like, even if it's not on his worst day, like he's heavy-handed, that kind of shit. Yeah. Right?
He's a machine.
Yeah. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You could win him over with some cocktails.
Probably.
You could win him over with some cocktails.
He loves drinking. So
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Especially Kool-Aid out of fucking...
The gallon of Kool-Aid.
God damn it, man.
So, yeah. If you're listening on Spotify...
maybe they'll plug it.
Does the follow like it? Yeah. Maybe they will. Maybe. We'll see. It's time. And then... We're also on Amazon Music,
mm-hmm.
Google Podcasts, whatever the fuck. The links are in the description below. I really don't know what it is.
We're in everything. We're everywhere.
We're almost everywhere. We're just not on Apple Music. Fuck Apple. I haven't got nothing against Apple. It's just I had to make an account. I still haven't had the chance to do that.
Yeah.
But when I get the chance, it'll go. It'll be on there. People will be able to read it. I'm like,
we're on Pornhub as well. Don't worry, guys. We upload these two.
Should we?
No. Well, maybe. They make good money.
We'd reach a wider demographic.
Where would we put it? What category?
Do they have a category for daddies?
Gays.
Hmm. There's bears.
There are bears.
But like I said, Tom and...
They have that market.
They have
the Pornhub bear market.
They have the Pornhub bear market. We gotta go somewhere else.
Yeah, fuck. We're pushed out.
Let's check out X Hamster to see what we can find over there. Yeah. We'll see what we can find. We'll put it up somewhere. But we'd have to use like porn titles.
Mm-hmm.
Like
Sub or Dom, our first episode.
Yeah.
Easily,
yeah. It would be like two guys Ram Steve from Minecraft.
Yeah.
Two guys, rail politicians. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, yeah, that's all the promotion. I think I'm gonna go to bed.
Yep. Good morning, good evening, and good night.
All right. we can't take that either.
There's no way that's trademark. Is that trademark?
I don't know. I mean, it's part. I don't think it is. I don't think
so either. Fine. Fuck you. Good night.
Fuck you. Good night. I love you. Bye.